Wrong Howie.
WQAM, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Hello, I'm the general manager of this radio station. And today is Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish New Year.
Almost.
In an effort to celebrate religious diversity and promote goodwill toward other faiths, we've brought in a member of the Jewish community to offer our Jewish listeners a greeting for the new year.
Hey, hey, Happy New Year! Hey, hey, that's it. Go home. Okay.
They're back, your favorite Jewish rock and roll nostalgia band. It's Rosh Hashanah with their greatest hits album, Sock Hop at the Synagogue.
My rabbi's back in corner, something says my baby.
Are they, my rabbi's back.
Yes, Rosh Hashanah is reformed to bring you 12 kosher cuts of hoppin' Hebrew hijinks.
That joy isn't good for Jews.
This album should be in every Orthodox rocker's collection. Rolling Stone gives it 5 stars of David.
Did I wonder, who wrote the book of Job?
Sock Hop at the Synagogue, new from Rosh Hashanah. Available in all record stores. We'll talk price when you get here. Don't pass over this album.
The Hebrew.
Oi.
1044 at 560, WQAM, happy Wednesday to you. I think the only way we're going to be able to salvage the format of this hour is like to take a break just about immediately, if not sooner, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I do. I know.
And then we'll do the other one like at about 56. So stand by, because we got a lot of spots to play, and we got to get those spots in so we can cash in the cash and get the money so everyone can get paid, and at least those who are still working at QAM.
The Howard Stern Show, Neil Rogers, mornings and midday, and sports around the clock, 560 QAM.
Were you drudge packing?
FPL is ready to answer your questions. Here is FPL spokesman, Geldy Kilowatt.
I can assure you, we're doing everything we can.
Oh, what's the reason you turned the power off before the storm hit?
It was a precautionary measure. Are you over there?
Why is there parts of Palm Beach County still without power?
We're waiting for the wind to be less than 35 miles per hour or less. They're not, like, no wind.
But the storm's gone.
Oh, yeah. Well, we got scared. But power's been restored to Worth Avenue. It was only out for 10 minutes. That's because those people are much better than all of you. They don't even gotta make even. Other than that, I can assure you, we are doing everything we can. And we got thousands of truck stations on the border of Alabama with banjos on their puppet.
Why is that?
What good will that do?
I defer to my emergency operations manager. Hey, Mo! Wake up!
I can assure you, we're doing everything we can. Can I go home now?
I'd like to close this press conference by announcing our new slogan we borrowed from the post office. Through sunshine, and that's about it.
10:50, 10 before 11 at 560 WQAM. Happy Wednesday to you. The good news, the Marlins won again yesterday. The even better news is we got a doubleheader at PP Park today. The bad news about that is it doesn't start till 3:05, so the pregame's not till 2:30. Says on my schedule, Jim Mandich from 2 to 2:30. Does anybody believe that the Mad Dog, a big hot shot like him, is coming in for half an hour?
No.
No way. They'll throw Curtis or somebody in there like that, kill a half an hour. Yeah. Big celebrities like Jim Mandich don't come in to do a half an hour. It's kind of like a warm-up for the pregame show. Do they?
No.
No. Anyway, that's the deal. The even better news is we found out that the Marlins have another doubleheader because of all these dang hurricanes on Monday. And the first game starts at 1:05, which means Monday, 12:30, we exit. Do you know about that?
No.
Do you know? Well, how'd you know? Anyway, bad news from Iraq again. Seems like bad news every day. Another dead American Marine. More than 200 U.S. troops are wounded in Iraq the past week, the Pentagon said yesterday. And the total since the invasion was launched in March 2003 is now 7,245 injured. Of the 219 wounded the last week, 81 were returned to duty, 130 others were not. The number of Americans killed and wounded has grown rapidly amid an intensifying and increasingly effective insurgency. There were more wounded over the past 5 months, about 4,000, than in the first 13 months of the war put together, when there were 3,300. The number of Americans killed as of Tuesday was 1,018, now it's 1,019. That includes 3 civilian employees of the Department of Defense. It does not include Army Specialist Keith M. Maupin, 20, of Batavia, Ohio, who was captured April 9th. His fate has not been officially resolved. And the beat goes on. Even though mission has been accomplished, boys and girls, everything is really great except for those few little problems there.
Right. Abu Ghraib.
How come? Where they started all that crap.
Why
what?
Do you only read the bad news coming from Iraq?
Right, that's right. Let's news. Read. Okay, here's all the good news from Iraq. Listen carefully. That's it. Beaded curtain today, or do I do the poll first? I don't know. I'm going to forget how I do this. Here's yesterday's poll result. How do you think you will die? 1,591 people cast their vote on this very pleasant topic. Old age or natural causes?
I'm dying over here.
591. Heart attack, 420.
I'm dying over here.
Cancer, 226. Boredom, 171.
I'm dying over here.
Traffic accident, 66. Suicide, 50. In a hurricane, 27. Murder, 22. Or in a terrorist attack?
Oh, my God.
Only 18. So evidently, the Neil Rogers audience isn't whipped up into a frantic frenzy like Tom Ridgett and some of the others in the Nazi Bund would have us be all whipped up into. Because if they can keep us scared and in a panic, then of course we'll say, oh yeah, we need four more years of this so we can be protected and safe. Let's be safe. Elkie Summers, she's safe. She was born, look at that, did you know she was born on my birthday? Wow.
I did not.
Well, now we just discovered this. November 5th, 1940, which means she's 2 years older than I am, and that means she's really old. Born in Berlin, one of my favorite cities in the world. What a great city. Oh, man. That is a fabulous city. It is beautiful. The people are beautiful. The food is great. Them bratwurst, man, there ain't nothing like them German weenies. Anyway, her filmography, let's see, that makes her, like I said, almost 44. I mean, I'm sorry, 64. Her movies include Nicht mit uns.
Yeah.
Well, it's a lot of German stuff here, man. Flashback. Doppeltes Spiel mit an, Alles nur Tarnung, and a whole bunch of other German stuff that I can't pronounce. Destiny Ridge, Severed Ties. It'd be bad to be reading a bunch of German stuff on era of Rosh Hashanah. Himmelsheim, Adventures Beyond Belief, Anastasia, the Mystery of Anna made for TV, the TV miniseries Peter the Great. Well, we all know who Elkie Summers is. Why am I even wasting my time reading this crap?
Right.
Prisoner of Zenda, The Double MacGuffin. The Pleasure Seekers, The Treasure Seekers, Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square, The Fantastic Seven, Top of the Hill, Exit Sunset Boulevard, Man in Pajama, Inside the Third Reich. Now we're getting a little more timely. Huh?
Howard!
No, it's closer to...
Abu Ghraib.
Okay. Okay, here's the deal on Hurricane, I mean Tropical Storm Jeannie. Are we pronouncing it Jeannie or Jean?
I don't know.
Well, why not?
I haven't been watching the news.
Shame on you, mister. Just because Ivan is going to blow the Gulf away, I mean, we ought to start worrying a little bit more about Tropical Storm Jeannie now. Because by the 5 and 5.30 and 6 o'clock news tonight, I guarantee the weather fairies will be hyperventilating and the forecasting it's going to come blow right through your living rooms. Guaranteed. Jeannie nearing hurricane strength as rain bands reach eastern Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands. We just can't catch a break, you know what?
Nope.
Just another good reason to stay the hell out of that whole area. When in doubt, stay the hell out. A hurricane warning is in effect for Puerto Rico and the U.S. Virgin Islands again, damn it. Man. A hurricane watch and a tropical storm warning in effect for portions of the northern and southern coast of the La República Dominicana from Cabrera southward to Santo Domingo. Tropical storm warning remains in effect for the British Virgin Islands, St. Kitts and Nevis. Tropical storm conditions also affecting other locations in the northern Leeward Islands, or as some people say, Leeward Islands, and I have no idea why they say that. Why do they say that?
I don't know.
At any rate, Jean is moving toward the west-northwest near 8 miles an hour, and this motion is expected to continue during the next 24 hours. On this track, the center of Jeannie will pass near or over Puerto Rico later today. Going to be a lot of blowing Ricans. Maximum sustained winds near 70 miles an hour with higher gusts. Some strengthening forecast during the next 24 hours, and Jeannie could become a hurricane before passing over Puerto Rico. Estimated minimum central pressure, 991 millibars, which ain't all that bad, but nevertheless, it ain't all that good. And if we have another hurricane, the forecast track map we got off of the Ivan one because it has nothing to do with you folks, and we, Eric, did a good job of putting a genie on there for you. Good job, Eric. As a matter of fact, it would seem to me probably there's a new one up right now or in a few minutes. So if you're worried about tracking genie and you're worried again for the umpteenth time, and this is getting pretty freaking ponderous if you ask me, with the plywood and the water and the generators and the batteries and the flashlights and the portable radios and all of these things, man. It's getting
all of these
really
things.
Just a little bit ponderous already because the Lord works in mysterious ways. And he's still punishing Teresa Lepore and all you bastards in Florida for fixing the 2000 election and causing all these innocent people to be dead now because of W. Bush and all his lying Nazi bastards.
That's right.
That's just my opinion.
Holy cow, Aaron's coming.
Prepare yourself for the ultimate showdown of evil. Alien versus Predator.
Run for your lives! Wait, who's there?
It's Freddy from Nightmare on Elm Street and Jason from Friday the 13th.
That's right. The ultimate showdown of evil just got eviler. It's Alien versus Predator versus Freddy versus Jason.
There's evil everywhere. Quick, let's hide behind this children's doll.
That's no doll. That's Chucky from Child's Play.
Now, the ultimate showdown of evil isn't just eviler. It's ultimater. It's Alien versus Predator versus Freddy versus Jason versus Chucky.
This can't get any scarier.
Oh, yes, it can. Look, it's the guy from the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
That's because now it's Alien versus Predator versus Freddy versus Jason versus Chucky versus Leatherface.
What are they all fighting about?
I think it's over who gets top billing.
This summer, horror has a really long name. Don't miss Alien versus Predator versus... Well, you get the idea. In theaters now.
Yeah, we get the idea. 1102 at 560 WQAM. Like I said, Marlins the next post. Doubleheader at PP Park. Get out there today. Just screw off from work and go and see the Marlins games. Now, what are they? The Cubs won last night. I don't care what Josh says. I know the Cubs won.
Everybody in the race won last night.
San Francisco won. I know that the Giants won. And Houston won.
That's right.
What about the Padres? Are they still hanging around? I guess they're close. Did they win? There. They're there?
Yeah, they're there. And they won.
See, he's trying to calm me down. They're there. Anyway, oh, and speaking of calming me down, guess who was on hyperventilating on CNN about a half an hour ago, and I was lucky enough to get some of that on tape. You won't believe when you hear this voice.
On the surf, which the waves have changed over the last couple of hours. Also, we've acquired this wind gauge that we've been using to unscientifically monitor the winds, because actually true winds can't be obstructed. They also have to be at least 33 feet in the air to get true measurement. But we've been noticing already that we've seen an increase in about 10 miles per hour since this morning. You know, it may be as a result of Charlie and the fact that a lot of people presume that the course of Charlie deviated somewhat, although, of course, the National Hurricane Center would certainly argue with that. It may also be that a lot of people saw what Francis did to the center of the state.
The unctuous Ricky Ticky Sanchez on CNN. It's the first time I've seen him on there. Have you seen him on CNN before?
No, not before today.
And hopefully that'll be the last time if we're lucky. Maybe he'll get blown away right there on the beach. Wouldn't that be a shame? Anyway, speaking of that Ivan deal, and, of course, now it's a Category 4, but it's got 140-mile-hour winds, and it's barreling right up the Gulf. And they really don't know where, because it's kind of like wiggly-wobbling a little bit, first to the west and then a little bit back straight north. And they're not really quite sure whether Mobile's going to get the big blow, or maybe Nalines, the big easy, ain't going to be so easy. And people are streaming. They're pouring out of there. So if you have any friends or relatives in New Orleans, I'd call them right now and say goodbye and wish them the best in their afterlife. Wouldn't that be a good idea? Tell them to get the hell out of there is what I would tell them. When in doubt, get the hell out. Now, this story in the Houston Chronicle News, I don't want to say that they're, well, maybe they're not exaggerating. Could be really bad. It says more than 1.2 million people in metropolitan New Orleans were warned to flee as 140-mile-an-hour Hurricane Ivan churned toward the Gulf Coast, threatening to submerge the below-sea-level city during what could be the most disastrous storm to hit in nearly 40 years.
Oh, my God.
Forecasters said Ivan, blamed for at least 68 deaths in the Caribbean, could reach 160 miles an hour, strengthened to Cat 5 by the time it blows ashore as early as tomorrow morning somewhere along the Gulf Coast. The National Hurricane Center has posted a hurricane warning for a 300-mile swath from Apalachicola in the panhandle of New Orleans and Grand Island, Louisiana. New Orleans, I guess they're not going to have too much of that southern comfort the next couple of days, right?
No, they'll need to.
They might be drinking it, but they're not going to be enjoying it too much. New Orleans residents streamed inland in bumper-to-bumper traffic in an agonizingly slow exodus amid dire warnings that Ivan could overwhelm the city with up to 20 feet of filthy, chemical-polluted water. Traffic on Interstate 10 from Louisiana was stop and go today all the way to Houston, where the hotels are filling up fast. Walter Maestri, I wonder if he's kin to the ex-Kansas City Athletics shortstop, Joe DeMaestri. Walter Maestri, an emergency manager in New Orleans, America's most vulnerable metropolitan area, has 10,000 This is just amazing. I don't even know if I want to read this.
Oh, go ahead.
America's most vulnerable metropolitan area, New Orleans, has 10,000 body bags ready in case a major hurricane hits. As Hurricane Ivan's expected path shifted uncomfortably close to the low-lying urban soup bowl, Maestri said yesterday he might need a lot more. If a strong Cat 4 storm such as Ivan made a direct hit, he warned 50,000 people could drown and the city could cease to exist. This could be the one, Maestri said. You're talking about the potential loss of a major metropolitan area. Well, then where the hell are they going to have the Mardi Gras if we don't have no more New Orleans?
I guess Texas.
Mardi Gras. Nah, they just ain't got the right kind of mugwumps in Texas that they got. They got cowboys in Texas. They don't have that good Cajun cooking. Join George and Boca Bryan today for happy hour. Oh, George wants to tell you a big song and dance about... I only wish you could. Wouldn't it be great if we could say all the things on the air that we talked about before the show every day?
Have a 20 share.
Oh, God. You only had the inside poop, and boy, there's a lot of poop going on at QAM these days. What's the latest poop on Hank? Does anybody,
No.
No, no. Every day I ask, and every day I'm told the same, by both Clarence and Muff, the Muffmeister, who's busy sharpening his dump finger up. They know nothing. And of course, we already knew that. I've seen some embarrassing crap in my life, but the way that that whole situation is being, I would say handled, but mishandled, is so grotesque and outrageous and unacceptable that it's just, there are no words to describe it. It's just idiotic. And I asked another question, well, I don't want to go into it, about what our sales department is selling. What personality are they selling in the afternoon? It's kind of like a bait and switch. If you're buying the Hank Goldberg show and you wind up with that, I mean, come on, get serious. Unless we're giving about a 90% discount. Join George and Boca Bryan today for happy hour, 5 to 7 in the p.m. at Treasure Island, located off the Palmetto, just north of the 122nd Street exit. This week's feature will be Stephanie Evans, and maybe you can get up close and personal, uptight and out of sight, with Stephanie, 5 o'clock this afternoon. Okay, here's our poll for today. And we need a whole bunch of additions on there, because I see we got some votes already, but we only have four choices up there, including one that I never heard of before. I heard of Daddy Warbucks, but I never heard of Daddy Warhols. But leave it to George.
Yeah, the Daddy Warhols.
Holly's 14, Sublime 8, Daddy Warhols and Supergrass don't have any. Supergrass is either a group or something George is trying to buy over at the barbershop later after work.
Both.
Most underrated rock group of all time, that's our question today. I voted for the Hollies, that was my pick yesterday. Of course, a lot of you punks out there would know the Hollies from Buddy Holly, but that's the way it goes, okay? So we need a lot more for that list. 567-0560, and we don't want any big name group, and we don't want nobody calling, the Moody Blues, the Bee Gees, you know. Underrated rock group, in other words, one that doesn't have a lot of notoriety, one that almost nobody talks about, one that ain't going to be whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's not complicated, but a lot of people will make it that because it's just your style. It's just the way the South Florida do things. We didn't really understand the most underrated rock group of all time. Very simple, and hopefully a group that somebody other than just yourself has heard of would be nice. That would help. WQAM, hello.
Neil, how are you?
Pretty good.
Unfortunately, I don't have any vote for your poll, but I did want to call in reference to your friend Rick Sanchez.
Yes.
I saw that little dweeb in Aventura Mall last week.
Yeah.
You're 100% right. He's about 5'4", got these beady eyes, kept staring at my wife, checking on her boobs. I was ready to knock his head off.
Why, has your wife got big boobs?
Well, she just had them done, so yeah.
I see, wow.
I mean, you know. Not bad, but
congratulations.
It was so funny when you played that. I said, man, I gotta let him know that, I guess he was with his kids.
Well, I might even play a little more of it.
Or it may just be the people are watching on television and seeing this huge Category 4 storm coming in what they presume to be their direction.
And I guess those people are really nervous because they don't want to wind up dead like the guy that Rick hit in front of the stadium, you know, in his car.
Unbelievable. Hey, did you watch that hockey game last night?
No, I did not. Why would I dignify these prima donnas? You know, the hockey, later on this afternoon, they're going to be officially announcing the lockout, and the season's going to be canceled, and they might not even have any hockey till 2006, they're saying now, because the two sides aren't even talking. So the idea that I would dignify them by watching a bunch of dog and pony show, a meaningless game, that, of course, here in Canada, we won, aren't we great? Yeah. Who the hell gives a crap? Screw them is what I say. And by the way, don't send the Panthers any money. Have a great day. Yeah, send the Panthers some of your money for those season tickets for a season that's non-existent. How many months have I been telling you that?
About 30, man.
Jesus, God almighty. It's like going into a restaurant and they're charging you for a great juicy steak up front, and then you give them the money to say, well, we don't have any steak. Yeah, but I just paid you for it. Well, you know, it's kind of like paying for hurricane shutters up front and then finding out they're not going up until after the hurricane clears. Stuff like that. You know what I'm talking about?
No, I have no idea.
Man, I'm biting my tongue so hard it's bleeding, big time. WQAM, hello.
I got a band for the poll.
Yes, sir, go ahead.
What?
I said, go right ahead.
They're a duo. It's called Nalgas.
Yeah, okay. WQAM, hello.
Yeah, like I have a name for your poll for the
yes,
day.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Sweet.
Sweet.
It's called Sweet. S-W-E-E-T.
I was talking about them this morning.
Okay, got it.
Great stuff.
Thanks, Pally.
Thanks, Dick.
Okay. WQAM, hello.
S-W-E-E-T.
QAM.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Neil. How are you?
Great.
Okay, two questions. First of all, for your poll, Queen, Q-U-E-E-N with Freddie Mercury.
Oh, okay.
They weren't really that much.
Get out of here! Get out of here!
I was listening to them
okay.
in the car this morning.
Yeah.
Bigger than God.
Right.
Well, at one point they were, but also.
Okay, but yeah, moving right along.
Aiming.
Yeah. I hear they're big on Mercury, is what I'm hearing.
The other thing is, regarding to the NHL contracts and everything, just out of curiosity, because I went on the NHL website, and they don't have anything basically based on what the players' associations are, or what they're trying to accomplish.
What the owners want is a salary cap, and the players' association don't want it because they're a bunch of greedy, selfish bastards, and Gary Bettman's a little dweeb twerp, and Bob Goodenough's got him by under his thumb, and as a result, they're at an impasse. They're farther apart now than they were 6 months and a year ago. There's no chance. In fact, my suggestion for this hockey season...
Forget about it.
Yeah. Have a great day, Alan. And don't send the Panthers any money, or any other hockey team. Did I watch that game last night? I wouldn't watch any of these prima donnas. I mean, just outrageous, unbelievable. Keep screwing over the fans, the paying public. Screw them, okay? A meaningless, stupid-ass game. And by the way, from what I read in the papers this morning, it was the same as the NHL, what's ruined the NHL, holding and grabbing and clutching at a bunch of crap. And, there he is again.
True measurement. You and I, Bill, talked earlier about this, and this is certainly something that is important, and that is the...
it's too close to lunch for Rick Sanchez.
You're listening to Neil Rogers, exclusively on 560 QAM.
Florida sucks.
He's John McCain, the guy that pushed them. But in 2000, Bush called him a traitorous doo-doo. He called his wife a druggie and trashed his daughter too. And now McCain's supporting him, hugging, kissing on the lips. He's John McCainiac. How can he put up with that crap? Must have people in his finger to support the little stinker. It's John McCainy.
Talking about Dick Cheney.
John McCainiac.
It's 11:18 at 560 WQAM. Anyway, this is going to be difficult, this poll. You know why?
Why's that?
Well, because you're going to say, well, oh, they're very popular, and they're in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and everybody knows them.
I'm going to say that.
Yeah, you are. For example, here's one that says from Grumpy, undoubtedly the greatest unsung rock blues group is the Animals. In fact, I was playing a little of that yesterday, remember? Which I would reach back there and get it, but
sure.
I'm too lazy. Also, don't knock the Brits. Oh, this is from some Brit. Well, like I said, don't put them on there. Everybody knows the Animals, Eric Burdon. Big, huge group, right?
Yeah.
Are we putting them on there or not?
Well, whatever you want. I mean, the question is underrated, so it's if you think they're underrated.
Yeah. The Animals. You see, we didn't say what group should have been more popular. That's true. Underrated. So even for that limey Brit, for that silly-ass twit who's probably full of Schmidt, we'll put that on there. Don't bug me again, okay? And I'll say whatever the hell I want about you silly-ass Brits. And isn't that nice that Batman was there on the balcony just in case the Queen came back from Balmoral? What a bunch of crap. Good thing the terrorists don't have to worry about all that security there at Buckingham Palace if they ever want to go after that Queen.
Blimey.
And all the other Queens inside there. Elmer says, could you please, please add Radiohead to your poll? It's done. Is it done?
It's done.
Good. The Kinks. Well, see, it's the same as the Animals, right?
I don't know. I mean, I like them a lot. I
Lola.
Didn't think they were underrated. They had a long history, long
well,
and illustrious history.
Put them on there.
All the way up to MTV Day.
Put them on there.
The
when
Kinks,
people talk
so.
About the greatest rock groups of all time, do they talk about the Kinks?
Not the greatest.
Underrated.
All right.
I said groups, plural groups, like maybe the top 10, the top 20, the top 30, the top...
About 30, man!
Like I just said. Put them on there. Just for kicks. The Kinks for kicks. And here's a good one. This is exactly the kind of group I had in mind, says Gary. Crowded House.
Indeed. Already stuck it on there.
Love Crowded House. I mean, that's exactly the kind of group we're talking about. Also, it says on your internet stream, instead of getting blessed silence during your breaks, we're getting that Major League Baseball disclaimer. Mm-hmm. Well, what does that mean? Major League Baseball disclaimer?
Some recording that we can't stream the Marlins because...
Oh, who cares? Hey, Gary, you're always bellyaching, always bellyaching. Bah, 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 bah. Just calm down, okay? We're doing the best we can on a horseball station with a horseball general manager and two intermediate goofballs who don't know my ass from their elbow, okay? So just relax, Gary. We're doing the best we can, and I think under the circumstances, we're doing pretty dang good. You know what I mean? I got so much stuff here, and I'm never going to get it in because this dang poll I come up with is we're going to have 80 million, which is good. That's the idea of it. Have a whole bunch of money, and then everybody would vote. But I got to mention this first. Explosives found in contractors' bags at JFK.
Oh, my God.
A government contractor was carrying highly explosive Soviet munitions from Afghanistan that were not detected until he arrived at JFK Airport, federal officials be saying today. Sean Marshall, a medic for defense contractor DynCorp, arrived at Kennedy on August 19 from the United Arab Emirates. He was trying to board a United Airlines flight home to California when he was pulled aside for a routine security check. A search of his bags by federal screeners found what police bomb technician described in an FBI complaint as a Soviet projectile point detonating fuse and a surface-to-air and air-to-air cartridge. Just the kind of stuff that most of us would have in our sack. Federal officials said they could not comment yesterday on the risk that the munitions posed to the flight, but the city police bomb squad determined the munitions were highly explosive, according to the FBI complaint. Oh, that's no threat to a flight. A little bomb like that, blow up a big jet like that? I don't think so. Well, Marshall also had 550 caliber bullets and four small arms cartridges, which he did not declare to United as required by law, according to the complaint made public yesterday. The Transportation Security Administration officers who searched Marshall's bags called police for the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey, which operates the airport. The fact that the TSA located these explosives indicated the system is working, they said. Right. Of course, the fact that he was at, came in and they didn't find him until he landed, that shows it's really working, doesn't it? The FBI sent agents to arrest Marshall at his Riverside, California home after the bomb squad analyzed the munitions and DynCorp officials said Marshall had no involvement in its training operations. A Port Authority spokesman said he couldn't comment on why Marshall was released. He faces charges of placing explosives on an aircraft and trying to place ammunition on a domestic flight without notifying the carrier. Could face 20 years in prison if convicted. I say just shoot his ass. That's right. I think it's about time we could pussyfooting around with all these terrorist types and would-be terrorists and people who look dangerous. Here's one that really pisses me off, but I'm sure that it's accurate. Most underrated, Jethro Tull. And let me ask you one simple question, okay?
Okay.
Are we out of gas?
That's Steely Dan.
I know. But every time I think of Steely Dan, I think of Jethro Tull. You want to know why?
Why?
Because I hate them both.
I see.
Same genre.
Really?
Same era. Huh?
Same genre.
Yeah.
Okay.
No?
No.
Get out of here.
Okay, bye.
Da, 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 da.
Steely Dan is jazz rock.
I know Steely Dan. Steely Dan, are we out of gas? Are we out of gas? Steely Dan blows, okay? If you think I'm putting Steely Dan on there, man, I'd rather put Ricky Ticky Sanchez on there before I'm putting Steely freaking Dan.
I didn't suggest it.
But is Jethro dull? I'm telling you, I'm not going to argue with you, okay? Because you are the expert.
We're arguing. All right.
11 o'clock this morning. Tropical Storm Jeannie. Much of the dynamical guidance calls for Jeannie to turn northwestern, even northward after 48 hours. On the other hand, the GFDL is a left outlier. What is that?
I have no idea.
Calling for Jeannie to track across La Republica Dominicana, Bahamas. What is this? Like I'm supposed to understand what the hell this mumbo jumbo from the National Weather Service is all about from the Hurricane Center? I have no idea what the hell that means. I looked at the, and by the way, nice job there, Eric. Eric put the 11 a.m. tracking map up on our website already on neilrogers.com, and it looks to me like it's moving further away from you folks, more to the east. Isn't that what it looks like if you take a puke at it right there?
Yes, it does.
Therefore, so this, again, this is our friend that faxes us all these things as if we don't have, you know, computers, but thank you anyway. But still quit underlining, trying to get me all whipped up into a frenzy and get the audience all worked up and pissed off. I'll say it again. Jethro Tull, Steely Dan, same era, okay?
That's,
not
yeah,
same genre, same that era. Was a misspoke, but same era.
Yeah. Are we putting Jethro Tull on there?
Yes, Jethro Tull. I just got through saying that. And you can put Steely Dan on there just to show what a good guy I am. Put Steely Dan on. There'll be some idiots out there vote for him. And by the way, are we still out of gas?
Yes, we are.
Good.
Although the stations are back open now.
No. WQAM, hello.
Frankie Lyman.
Jesus Christ.
Hey, Frankie Rocco,
Lyman.
Stop faxing, Rocco.
Frankie
stop.
Lyman and the, what?
If Rocco doesn't stop faxing, I'm going to go get him.
Good.
We can't read the faxes,
Rocco. We're going to send Ron to get him.
Oh.
We'll just put Ron on the sofa and chain him there. He'll never get out.
Hi. Hi.
Now, what was I just saying before you interrupted me with some crap?
Are we out of gas?
Something extraordinarily important about some group and all. It's just bad. You never get it again.
Uh-oh.
Man, it'll never come back. It was like life and death. Something about, oh, Steely Dan. Isn't that what it was about?
Yeah, were you going to say something about Donald Fagen? Were you going to make a joke about his name? Is that what you were going
to
do?
No, I just was going to say that they still suck.
You're listening to Neil Rogers. On 560 QAM.
Neil? God?
Absolutely. Goodbye, Teresa Lepore. Won't see you no more. We can count on Lucky Chad, but you don't got no job no more. So pack your desk and mosey out the door. You stupid skanky whore. You go treat your yeast infection. I don't think I gotta mention we had enough elections lost by you, you dour stupid pascunyards. You're all done screwing us now, so get the hell on the towel. You're not welcome in Florida. And Pat Buchanan, he wouldn't touch you with Dick Cheney's thing. Now there's one less county to rig for the Neocons. You lost your stupid bitch, go find something else to do. Like Mass and Gill, you smelly too.
11:30 at 560 WQAM, 88 votes on the poll. Oh, and before we give you the poll result, Lepore says she was crucified for problem in 2000 presidential election. If it was good enough for Jesus, it's good enough for you, Teresa.
If only.
Yeah. 2 weeks after Palm Beach County voters rejected her, they said, bye-bye, Teresa, you silly-ass bitch. You evildoer. Supervisor of Elections Teresa Lepore isn't apologizing for past mistakes or agonizing over missed opportunities. Instead, she had harsh words for South Palm Beach County voters who came out against her in droves and the Democratic leaders who pushed her ouster. The whipping up especially of the South County Democrats into a feeding frenzy over the year 2000, the 2000 general election, just regurgitating all that, played a major role in her defeat, Lepore said Tuesday. It's just amazing you can do everything right for 30-plus years.
About 30, man.
And you have one, albeit not small, incident, and you're crucified for it forever after. I don't see people should forget it, but you can't change it, so you need to concentrate on the future. You can't go back. And that's right, just like Miriam Elephant and Broward, you can't go back in there either again, honey. You're done. You're out. Adios, arrivederci. Totzins, dewey. Plenty of factors contributed to her. Well, we don't want to go into the whole background of that, but the fact of the matter is the voters spoke and they said, get lost, you're incompetent, you're an idiot. Take your butterflies and your connect the dots and arrow ballots and get lost. Stick them where the moon don't shine, honey. Get out of our face, you idiot, you. Anyway, the poll result so far. What is the most underrated rock group of all time? Good question, thank you. 88 votes, Hollies 26, Sublime 25. That's where the horse races are. I'm glad to see so many people out there agree with me on a Hollies. Isn't that amazing? I'm shocked.
Yes, it is.
Since I'm the one that's got such crappy taste in music, alleged.
Well, you can't help it.
And, oh, and by the way, I looked it up in the book because I know that I played them on Zeta at the same time. And it was Jethro Tull, their only two hits, Bungle in the Jungle and Living in the Past, both of which sucked big time. 72 and 74, okay?
Uh-huh.
Steely Dan, Do It Again in 72. Yeah. Ricky, Don't Lose That Number, 74. And then, of course, they lasted longer. They were around after that. So when I say same era, I'm absolutely correct. And same genre as far as I'm concerned because, you know, you don't understand. There's one word that sums them both up.
Crap.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. I didn't know you meant that genre.
That kind of genre. In other words, is crap, pseudo-intellectual crap.
I wasn't arguing the era thing with you.
Bungle in the Jungle, my ass. Then we do have Frankie Lyman. Do we have Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers on there or not?
Are you kidding me?
We better have her. That guy's going to come to the station and get Josh. I'm not kidding you. Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers.
All
that
right.
Guy's obsessed.
You better spell Lyman
for wants,
Josh.
It's a good thing he don't live in California because if he dug up Frankie's body, God only knows what he would do with it. Although I think I got a pretty good idea. Anyway, Holly's 26, Sublime 25, Steely Dan 11. See, I told you they belong down there. A lot of people like Steely Dan. And hey, a lot of people like vanilla ice cream and McDonald's too. Fine. More power to you. The Kinks 8, The Animals 6, Radiohead 6, Jethro Dull 4, Sweet 4,
Sweet,
Supergrass 3, Daddy Warhols 1, and Crowded House don't have any out of the first 94 votes. Are you people crazy or what?
Yes.
Obviously, they think they're rated just fine.
Crowded House is great.
I like Crowded House.
Maybe they're a little bit too fey for this crowd. I'll give you another one. Well, you won't agree, and it probably not didn't belong on there. I was going to say R.E.M.
They're huge.
They're gigantic.
Right.
Well, yeah, but hey, you like R.E.M., you must be gay. Remember that call?
Sure.
What an idiot. Oh, yeah, you must be. Well, guess what? I am. How do you like that? And I do love R.E.M. And they actually make music that says something. I know that's unusual, but they make music that says something. And that last big hit, what the hell was the name of that? That unbelievable video, Visions of
Sugar Plums.
No, seriously, what was the... Well, it'll come to me. 10cc, what do you say to that?
Sure.
Yeah, why not? I could live without them, but they're okay.
Yeah, I know.
One of the most underrated groups of all time is Crazy Horse with Nils Lofgren, Danny Whitten, Ralph Molina, and Billy Tell, but they were also Neil Young's backup band in the early 70s. Crazy Horse.
Okay.
Shirley Peters used to go to the Crazy Horse with all her girlfriends to see all them naked guys, see what one looked like. Put Husker Du on the poll. Husker Du.
Husker Du.
Oh, I see. Husker Du. As in 23 Skidoo?
Something like that, yeah.
Band from Minneapolis in the 80s that influenced tons of bands, including Nirvana. Oh, God, and don't be saying Nirvana. They're so overrated that there are no words to even describe it. How's he doing, by the way? He ever healed up yet or not?
Not.
Chronic Rick, why do you keep sending me his faxes? I must have done something really evil to you, you know?
Oh, I didn't know you didn't want his faxes anymore.
Every day. Richard Mason. I mean, if it was from Perry Mason, we know about him.
Blaming.
Raymond Burr. In fact, I heard that he had a burr in the saddle is what I heard.
It burrs.
He's got three. It says also, please let Greg read it, that at least we know what time Air America starts. Well, if you're listening to Air America, Rick, then all I can say to you is that's one more reason not to read your stupid-ass chronic faxes on here, okay? Air America, my fat, pimply ass. God. Nothing like hearing the goddess the day afterward. And then hearing all the whining on there with Al Franken, frankly speaking. And that broad that I just can't believe that she's even on. I can't believe either one of them is on there. What's her name again?
Friendly Emperor.
Oh, yeah, she's really great. Al, that was a funny bit you just played. Do you think Carrie's got a chance?
Hi.
Let's see, could you please add Marillion to the list? What the hell is that?
Marillion. I'm afraid that's Marillion? A new one on me.
Oh, well, you said it like didn't he say that like in kind of a condescending way, like I'm supposed to know who that is?
Marillion, dummy. Never heard of him.
Yeah. I've told you a million times, man, that they're great. Okay, put them on there. Probably no such group. They're probably like Menomina.
I know that.
5670560. I'm never going to get to all this good stuff here. Damn it. Well, I got to do this one. Yeah, play a little of that. Menomina. Let's have a big argument about that and who done it and what it's all about. Menomina.
Yeah.
I love it. George W., it's almost as good as Na Na Hey Hey Kiss Him Goodbye, but nevertheless. George W. Bush's commanding officer in the Texas Air National Guard wrote memos more than 30 years ago.
About 30, man!
Objecting to efforts to gloss over the young lieutenant's shortcomings and failure to take a flight physical, the officer's former secretary said Tuesday night, but Marion Carnox of Houston said she thought four memos unveiled by CBS News last week were forgeries, not copies of the one she typed at the time. Knox, 86, worked for 23 years at Ellington Air Force Base in Houston, served as a typist for Lieutenant Colonel Jerry B. Killian, who of course now is dead, then Bush's squadron commander and several other officers. See, the most interesting part of this deal is the big argument is, oh, well, what about the typewriter and are these the original ones? That's not the question. The question was, did these represent what actually was being said? And the answer is positively.
Yes.
In a brief interview yesterday, she confirmed that Killian had concerns about Bush's failure to take his physical exam in 72, which prevented him from flying. He might have had a little bit of a nose problem. And about efforts by higher-ups to protect the future president from the fallout. Knox told several newspapers that Killian kept the personal files on Bush and other topics in a desk drawer as a way of covering his back in anticipation of later questions about his actions. She retired in 79 before Killian's death, said she didn't know what became of the files. So there you go. So she said the four letters that they're showing look like forgeries, but nevertheless they represent accurately what he had written and what he was saying, and they knew that we had an AWOL drunk, coke-snorting future president. See, again, they keep focusing on the wrong things because they keep letting them change the subject. The fact is you got a draft-dodging vice president and president without any shadow of a doubt, And they're attacking, and their big attack on their opponent is because he was a Vietnam War hero and because he came back and protested the war, which, of course, was the right thing to do because anybody old enough to remember knows it was the most one of the most horrendous, grotesque mistakes in history. Even more grotesque, at least to this point, than the invasion of the illegal Iraq attack.
Oh, yeah, he's just like Jane Fonda.
Only she did a better workout, obviously. WQAM, hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
I just wanted to request you putting Joy Division on there.
Joy Division?
Yes.
Okay.
Wonderful group. And Jethro Tull also had Aqualung and Motor... What was it? Motor...
Locomotive Breath.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry. Why did you bring that up? That's almost as bad as hearing Rick Sanchez again. Okay,
thanks
a lot, Pally.
Bye.
Okay. Got it?
We got it. Joy Division.
We're going to have 80,000 names on this poll, and you can peruse them and choose them, and quite frankly, most of them lose them.
You're listening to Neil Rogers exclusively on 560QAM.com.
Coming up tonight on Inside the Behind, the True Hollywood Celebrity Music Biography Profile Story. In one song, he mentions banging seven women. He was Lou Bega.
A little bit of Monica in my life, a little bit of Erica by my side.
Well, I do not want to brag, but
Lou Bega is cavalier about his mega hit, Mambo No. 5.
A man like me has so many appetites. I must snack often, no?
God, is this guy for real? Desperate to get a viewpoint which conflicted with this obnoxious motherfucker, we sought out psychiatrist Dr. Jane. All men suck.
This Lou Bega is a dysfunctional sex addict. He has delusions of grandeur and a severe phallic obsession. He should be castrated and forced to eat it. I mean, really, you don't catch me having sex with seven men ever in my lifetime.
Clearly, our attempt to discredit Lou Bega had backfired. So, we went the other way and found porn star Ron Jeremy.
Jesus, that's fantastic! You know, I don't think I ever did it with seven women in my whole career. I mean, at one time, four was the most they gave me. But then it kind of evens out, because I was, you know, let's just say I bet Lou Bega didn't put it in all the places I did. So for me, four women was more like 10 or 12. You know, come to think of it, that Lou Bega is an asshole. Who is he to say he's better than me?
Will you listen to this? Typical man. They all have to whip out their things and brag about who gets to do me. I mean, not me. Oh, hell yes, I mean me. Do me, Lou!
Of course, my lovely, for that is what I do. I service the lovely ladies.
Oh, Christ, we're back to him again. Will somebody please kill me? It's a big, juicy, sopping wet like a show business. Tonight, on Inside the Behind.
Martha Stewart's going to begin her sentence ASAP.
That its best days are still ahead of it.
Okay, good.
Plunger.
Doesn't it make you want to go right to Kmart if we still had that Kmart out there by the Sawgrass and buy all that Martha Stewart stuff?
No, Kmart sucks.
A whole bunch of sheets and linens and tablecloths and
bath mats and
lingerie and pink slippers, stuff like that.
Bathing caps.
Somebody says, how about Berlin with Terry Nunn? It just kind of takes my breath away when I read that. Take my breath away. Yeah, why not?
Sure.
They're okay.
I got a good one, but
nobody will know who they are, and they really were excellent, and I think they're done. I think they're finito, which is, I don't know, I think it's a communist bunch of crap. Band Ohne Namen.
All
great.
Right.
Remember I played some of their stuff on the air? I don't think you liked it, but then again, you didn't like anything.
No, not me.
Band Ohne Namen. But we won't put it on there because nobody in this audience will know who they were. And we'll put it on there anyway, just for kicks.
For German kinks.
Band. Can you spell band? Good. Ohne, O-H-N-E, Namen, N-A-M-E-N. Got it, Josh?
No.
Band, B-A-N-D.
Yeah, you got that part.
Ohne, O-H-N-E, Namen, Namen, N-A-M-E-N. Band with no name, Band Ohne Namen. Great. In fact, I got some over here. I'm going to play a few seconds of it just to aggravate the audience. Let's see, the Padres lost, you ignoramus. Well, how the hell am I supposed to know? That's Josh's department. He said they won. Don't be giving me no ignoramus crap. And for the poll, Marshall Tucker Band. That's a good one.
Ooh.
I didn't say I liked them.
Yeah,
I said that's a good one.
You and me both.
That's for Giants?
That's for the overrated poll.
Right. Look, we're asking for their opinion.
No, we'll
and like I said,
there,
a lot of people like a Big Mac, okay? A lot of people for lunch today are going to go to McDonald's or Burger King, God forbid, and eat that famous anus burger or whatever it is. Giants are a half game ahead of the Cubs. Astros are one behind the Giants. Marlins are two out, and the Padres are three out. Thank you very much for, we just seem to be having a lot of, and I don't know why, because I should just look at my, well, the problem in my morning newspaper, the National Post, which I get delivered, and I really hate that right-wing rag, but They always, for some reason, don't have a lot of the scores the night before, even though some of those games are over, like by 10 o'clock, but they go to bed early. All those right-wingers go to bed real early. Jay says, King Crimson. There you go. That's perfect for our poll. Who the hell needs them? See, now, didn't I say this at the beginning of the show? The Moody Blues, Dave the Cop. You are just...
You use them
as take your
example.
Cardinals and stuff them, by the way. Is Stan Musial still playing? What about Joe Cunningham? The Moody Blues. No, you can't put the Moody Blues on there. How could you say they're underrated?
Auditorium filling bigger than God's
right, the Moody
career.
Blues, my God. I think Dave the Cop probably goes to bed and sleeps on white satin sheets because he's so obsessed with the Moody Blues, don't you? Spends his nights on white satin.
Yeah.
I didn't want to say it. Here's the poll result so far. I'm so sorry I said it. God, we only got a little over 2 hours to go. You better hurry up. Of course, I could save a lot of this stuff for tomorrow. Oh, and I got some great news, okay? Just to show you that John Kerry, even though he looks like Herman Munster and Fred Gwynn, the same guy, Kerry hires Alabama woman fired for a sticker. Yesterday we had the story about the woman in Alabama who got canned in some mugwump place by some mugwump boss because she had a Kerry sticker on her bumper sticker on her car, and she got fired at it. Well, Democrat John Kerry has a new campaign working, helping him drum up support in Alabama. After hiring a woman who was fired for displaying the presidential candidate's bumper sticker on her car, Kerry called Lynn Goble yesterday after reading a newspaper story describing how she'd been fired last Thursday from her job packing cellulose insulation at a Moulton, Alabama plant. Goble said her former employer had told her she could either work for him or for Kerry. She said Kerry told him, let her know that as of today you're working for John Kerry, is what he said.
Right.
He was proud of me for standing up for what I believe in, the newly employed 41-year-old said of her quick phone call with a candidate. Goble said Kerry didn't offer too many details about her new position. And after having seen her, I'm sure it's not the prone position. She'll be helping the campaign and maybe traveling a little as it gets closer to the election. How do you like that? Nice going, John. Good
move.
Let
me tell you something.
Oh, he's so weak. Oh, here's a good one. Now, this is good. I mean, even though, of course, see, I don't know. Maybe it's not so good. The Doobie Brothers. I mean, they're big.
Yeah.
But then again, the animals are big, huh?
No, because that's one of those bands that's good for the poll because that's one of those bands that people argue about.
See, this is a very tough one, but that's good because that's the idea of a poll. If we all,
right.
if it's so obvious, then what's the point of putting a poll on there, you know?
Kill time.
But if it's a poll where there's like all these different shades of gray, as the monkeys would say. How about the monkeys? It's just a joke. Just a joke.
Glad you said that fast.
Okay, just a joke. Although, you know something?
Oh, it's already on there. Too late.
The monkeys did have some good songs.
Yeah, they did. But
even though they were like mostly non-musicians.
Really
except, of course,
band.
For Davy Jones, who played a mean tambourine as opposed to a green tambourine.
Right.
How about the Lemon Pipers? Just a joke. You got to say just a joke real fast or Josh gets it on there.
It's on.
The Lemon Pipers. Not to be confused with the Lennon Sisters.
I also stuck the Archies on there.
This. Yeah, the Archies were great. In fact, didn't they do that Sugar Shocker bit? What is the most underrated rock group of all time is our poll. And don't forget, also, you can take a look at that 11 a.m. Tropical Storm Genie, which may become Hurricane Genie, just in case you're a little bit nervous these days, a little bit unsettled, unglued, with all of this crap that's been going on lately. Hollies 33, they continue being in first place. During the break, I'm going to reach over and grab that disc, play just 10 seconds of Hollies, 10 seconds of the Animals, and even maybe 10 seconds of Band Autonomen. Hollies 33, actually, as I recall a couple of years ago when I played that, you liked a couple of their songs.
Band Autonomen? I didn't mind them. They're dance.
Pretty good. And you loved that video where they mocking the Catholic Church and they had the nun. And he was running around naked and the nun was like, oh, my God. And she kept looking and looking. Hollies 33, Sublime 31, The Kinks 18, Steely Dan 17, They Should Burn in Hell, Jethro Tull 14, and then they won't have to worry about if they're out of gas. Radiohead 11, The Animals 8, Sweet 6, Supergrass 5. That grass sure is super. 10cc 4, yeah. Huskadoo 3, Berlin 2. It sounds so stupid saying that. Huskadoo. Is that like Yishkadal and Yishkadash?
Yishkabibble.
Crazy Horse 2, Crowded House has got a pair. Band Autonomen's got one, and that wasn't my vote because I would have changed it. I would have voted for them instead of the Hollies. Hollies don't need my help. Band Autonomen's got one. God bless you, whoever you are out there, somebody with great taste.
Some crowd.
Good. I'm going to tell you right now, you would love Germany.
Oh, yeah.
I'm telling you right now, you'd love it. In fact, when Al Goldstein sends you over there, I don't know if he's got an apartment there you can stay in. I know he sure as hell doesn't have a house there anymore.
I don't think he's got an apartment he can stay in here.
Maybe he has a homeless shelter he can stay in that he hangs on it.
A youth hostel.
Division One. Now, look at the way he spelled that. Manilian. I thought you were giving him the faxes on these so we could at least come close to spelling it right. It's got L-L-I-O-N. He's got...
I think that's how they spelled it on the fax.
No, they did not. One. Batty Warhol's one. And no votes yet for the Doobie Brothers. Out of 160, they got no votes. The Doobie, Doobie, Doobie. Man, I thought this crowd was into Doobies. King Crimson None, Marshall Tucker Band None, and Frankie Lyman. The Teenagers don't have any yet. We put it on there for you, putz, and you didn't even vote for it yet. What is your story? Huh?
I have no idea.
Probably can't afford a computer. Huh? He'll probably go to the Internet Cafe. He'll get around to it.
Library, it's free.
WQAM, hello. WQAM, hello.
Yes, hi, Neil Rogers Show?
Yes, sir, speaking.
Oh, yes, yeah, just like to tell you Grand Funk Railroad.
What was it?
Grand Funk Railroad.
What is he saying?
Grand Funk Railroad.
Oh, Grand Funk Railroad. He sounded like he had 4 pounds of mush in his mouth or something.
I don't want to repeat what he said the way he was saying it.
Grand Funk Railroad. I heard what he said, but it was just like,
Grand Funk Railroad.
Yeah, it was kind of like that. Like he had a shoe over his puss. Yeah, that's a good choice.
Sure.
Huh? Love Grand Funk. Mm-hmm. Although, well, I'm not going to go in it. WQAM, hello.
Neil, how's it going?
Pretty good.
Listen, I don't have a suggestion for the poll, but I actually wanted to ask you about a similar one you had a while back.
Right.
A couple of years ago, you asked who we thought were the worst new artists, and I suggested Macy Gray, and you basically ripped me a new one.
Not because we like her music, because we just like Macy Gray, because she's funny, that's all.
But, I mean, she's awful. She sounds like
that's
she has emphysema.
Oh, there's so many bits now that come to mind that I should be playing, the girl from with emphysema and all these others.
That'll work.
Yeah, and the Macy Gray bits, too. Okay, Pally, well, you were right. She sucks. But we like her anyway. He didn't get it, see?
They say my voice is that just perfect mix between the munchkins and Stevie Nicks. You try to understand what I say. Try to understand what I mumble. Words that I'm singing are clear. My vocals sound weird to you.
Okay, I'm going to play a little bit of some of this. In fact, during the break coming up, since we have nothing but commercials and breaks all the time anyway on the show, we don't have any show left. I'm going to find that Band of Nomin bit. Oh, we also have Moody Blues on here. Oh, man, this might just be the greatest song of all time. Let's do that again, not.
Oh, for a month.
Oh, that'll only take about 6 or 7 months. Then we won't have to worry about these stupid pain-in-the-ass polls anymore. This could be, like I said, I do like Nights on Broadway.
We've already
which is the Bee Gees.
Oh, it's such a good song.
Yeah. What I'm trying to say. But I will say this, and I know that sounds really bad, especially on your AM radio, but even if we're on your FM radio, it doesn't make any difference because when that came out, I would say 68, 69-ish. I'll look it up in the book. I thought to myself, and I was a disc jerky on WTPS in Kalamazoo, Michigan, no less, and I remember playing that on the air, and I thought to myself, that sounds awfully, like, distorted. Like, were they listening? I mean, when they mastered that thing, were they listening to the sound of it? Am I wrong or right?
No, you're right. It's that distorted on purpose sound.
Oh, I'm way off on the air. I guess we were playing it as an oldie in 68. It was 327.65. Reached number 10 on the charts. And just a 66, great...
66, yeah.
65.
Brian was guessing. So you're wrong, Brian.
Let me say it again. 327.65 right here. And what was I talking about? Nights on Broadway? That was the Bee Gees. I was talking about Nights in White Satin.
Yeah.
Well, a lot of nights. So many nights in so little time. That's what the Brits say. So many nights. 11.56... 4 minutes till noon at 560 WQM. Don't forget, have we had an announcement on who's going to be doing 2 to 2.30? Because I'll bet Greg's life on it ain't going to be Mad Dog. They're not even going to tell us that. You know, it's one thing that Clarence and Duff every morning, you know, come in and schmooze a little bit, which I'm tired of that. I'd like some information. The audience would like to know what the hell is going on, and at least this should be one question that you morons can answer, you asswipes. Somebody will be on between 2 and 2.30. And then at 2.30, you got the Marlins on Drek. At 3.05, Expos and Marlins doubleheader at the stadium at PP Park. Eddie K. after all the baseball stuff. The second game starts 30 minutes after the conclusion of game numero uno. And again. Again and again and again, I'm doing the wrong spot here. Well, we don't want to do the generic one. We want to do the one about the hurricanes and about the fact that a lot of people got their carpets messed up. And as a result, if you had flooding in your house, you ought to be calling Dry Concepts, who for over 25 years have helped you keep your carpets clean and healthy and your house looking great. Right now, Dry Concepts stands ready to help you return your home to normal if you had water damage from Hurricane Francis. They've made arrangements to be a staging area for water damage restoration services. Help came in from all kinds of northern states with an abundance of equipment to help you with your restoration process. If you need help, just call the main number toll-free at 1-800-248-5071. That's 1-800-248-5071. If you can't get through to that number, they got three other numbers for you, 954-214-6924 or 954-444-9276 or 954-214-6923. Again, if you had water damage from Hurricane Francis, Dry Concepts is standing by to help restore your home back to its normal state and look brand spanking new and really great. Call them toll-free, 1-800-248-5071. That's 1-800-248-5071.
You're listening to Neil Rogers, exclusively QAM.
Hello, love, this is Davy Jones of the Monkees. Whenever I'm in Miami, I listen to WQAM's Neil Rogers Show, 12 to 1 hour.
I'm dying over here.
Short and pale and thin and sickly, the girl with emphysema keeps smoking, and when she passes, she flicks her ash and goes. When she smokes, she's like the chimney that shoots up clouds and smells so nasty that when she passes gas and goes. Oh,
that was raspberry, don't get panicked.
But she wants to quit badly. Coughing up big chunky lungs. Yes, she would give them up gladly. But each day when she has to go pee, she sits on the can and lights three. Short and pale and thin and sickly, the girl with emphysema goes smoking, and when she passes, she smiles with big yellow teeth.
I sure hope there's no more raspberries in this, don't you?
Oh, raspberries?
Yeah.
Right. Or
maybe
strawberries.
A couple of poison berries.
Poison berries.
So smoky. How can she tell where she's going? Yeah, she would give them up gladly. But each day when she has to go pee, she sits on the can and lights three. Short and pale and thin and sickly, the girl with emphysema goes smoking, and then she flashes that smile with big yellow teeth and gunk underneath. She just cannot breathe. It's only a wheeze.
12:03.
Can I have a light? Please.
At 560 WQAM. Got a bunch of faxes here. NRBQ, it says, best unknown underrated, should have been a big band, kicked major ass, says Harold, and we'll put it on there right immediately. NRBK.
All right.
BQ.
NRBQ.
Right. Neil Rogers Barbecue. PR Ralph, your good close personal friend, says, so by now, Mad Dog has forgotten that his Michigan Wolverines lost to the Holy Irish. He must be pissed off. Michigan lost to Notre Dame?
Yeah.
No. Yeah. To a girls' school? You gotta be schmitten me, man. That is embarrassing to this Notre Dame team. Oh, that's that Brady Quinn, man. He's dangerous. See, Michigan's upset because they used to have the good-looking quarterback when they had the Tom Brady. Maybe it's the Brady Bunch that Michigan's all about. Well, that's good. That's bad. He says, I have one effing comment for Greg Reed. Bring back Hammer, get rid of the hoe. Bring back Hammer, get rid of Moe. Says, doesn't he have an early bird special to go to? His morning show was bad, but his afternoon show just drives me to drink, says PRL. He is not happy with you, Mo. He is PO'd and pissed off and fired up. Here's one that says the Talking Heads. That's exactly what we're talking.
Right.
Here's one that says cream. No thanks, I take mine black. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Cream is another good one. Perfect example.
Mm-hmm.
And, let's see, here's one that says, how about Rush, eh? Alex says, the good old Canadian band, Rush. Excellent choice. Wouldn't you agree? Yes.
Okay, yeah, sure.
What?
That was my first
I didn't
concert.
Say you liked them. I said they're underrated. Well, you don't even like Band on a Night.
Missing you, missing you. Like the sun that is over. Missing you.
No, it's not the Band on the Wall, Josh. This is good.
Yeah, right. Anything George don't like, they're gay.
Gay.
Baby.
Like guys that play slots in a casino.
Yeah. See the girl with symbols on her fingers entering through the door. Ruby glistening from her navel, shimmering around the floor. Cause I don't want a day of my life.
Yeah.
Now she dancing, going yeah. Through the moon.
Okay, that's enough of the Hollies. Hollies were great, and they are leading the way right now. 37. We got a real Haas race.
You don't have the year
Hollies,
that I
and
there,
Sublime to Ridiculous has got 36.
Yeah,
what?
Sublime will beat them.
Why do you say that?
Well, that was my vote, and they're better.
He's polling. Well, guess what, Josh? With all due respect, we don't give a flying crap about what your vote was. That doesn't mean it's going to be number one, although it was a good choice.
You just discovered a whistle. You don't have the air that I breathe on that CD, do you?
The air that you breathe on the CD, well, if it is, they're looking pretty nasty. In fact, it's like that water they were talking about in New Orleans.
Chemical
the air that I breathe, why would that be on here?
Because they did that song.
I understand, but this is not, this is a
oh, I thought it was
best
a
of the
Hollywood's 60s, greatest
25
hits.
Smash hits, and you have to be very careful the way you say that, from the 60s. I mean, it's got some sure. Other good stuff. Remember the other day I played, going to the Marlin game, I played one of my very favorites of all time. And I certainly wouldn't put them on the poll because it's not a great group, but Small Faces and a medley of their smash, Ichiku Park, where he hangs out.
Over bridge of sight.
And I'll tell you another good group, too, although we won't put them on there, and I better not mention the name because Josh will put it on there right away. From the British Invasion. Searchers.
You're still searching?
Huh?
I saw her today. I saw her face.
And how about Marmalade? Not. And here's one that definitely belongs on there, I tell you right now. Huh? Huh? Even though you don't like him, and I'm not that crazy about him either.
Why did you say I didn't like the Turtles?
The Turtles, baby. Can you spell it?
I love the Turtles.
And when I said I was going to play a little bit of the Animals, too, because that Brit get all upset if I don't play Eric Burdon and the Animals. One thing about Eric Burdon, man, he sure was ugly.
On there for Brian.
What do you mean for Brian? I'm a bigger Grassroots fan than that little bald-headed twerp will ever be. Grassroots is a magnificent choice.
People tell me there ain't no use in trying.
No.
Oh, and you know who else we probably would put on there if Rick Shaw were listening right now? That's just a joke.
Okay, good.
Okay, so many groups in so little time.
Right,
but when he starts singing in German, that kind of leaves. And, of course, we got the Jew holidays coming up anyway, so the Jewish audience is busy going and doing their thing. Now, let's see. I've forgotten. It's been so long since I've been in all that Jewish crap. Rosh Hashanah, New Year, what are we supposed to do besides go to shul and pay the dues so that we can get in there and they won't kick us out? What are we supposed to be doing?
Party.
Oh, yeah. And eating a lot.
Party.
Then we have to have Yom Kippur so we can make up for it. Let's see, on the poll it says Joy Division is listed as Division, not that it's going to matter. Joy Division is listed as Division. I guess Eric's going to have to change it and bail your ass out on that, Josh.
He will. Well, Josh is getting the Tony's food right now, so I'm covered.
Chronic Todd in Hollywood says the winner has to be, and this is a great choice, Todd, XTC. And I sure wish I had that with me right here. Do you have it somewhere there?
We have something somewhere. Let me look in my music.
What is the name of that thing?
Dear God is the name of the song.
Dear God, that's it. Do we have it?
One moment, please.
I used to play that thing all the time. Dear God.
I got
that is
like
just
10 XTC songs in here at my fingertips, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
I love them hard. There's your
dear
God.
Oh, and that's it.
Yeah, but that's not as good as... Oh, it's a little bit more level on this thing, too. Anyway, that's Making Plans for Nigel. They actually had hits in other countries, not here.
Oh, well, of course. Most of the good groups have big hits in other countries, but not in America because they're not commercial enough and because the stations won't play them, and so nobody has any idea who they are. So as a result, American music, basically about 90% of it blows. But that's just the way it goes. And, of course, like I told you before the show, I was watching, like, MTV. And MTV don't play any videos.
Nope.
They don't play any music,
nope.
Okay? Much Music plays videos. All the other versions of MTV play like MTV, too. They play music videos. But MTV, they're too busy schmoozing and losing. They got that jackass running around. What's his name again? Carson Daly.
Yes, running around Daly.
What an idiot he is, man. He just makes me vomit. He's got such an arrogant attitude. See, if you're going to be arrogant and have an attitude, you better have some talent to go with it. If you got a big ego, you better really produce, you know what I'm saying? Because if you don't, you'd look like a
absolutely
jack wipe. By the way, did you check with Joyce to make sure we can say ass wipe?
No, I did not.
Well, I'll say it a lot today just to make sure, just in case tomorrow she says, oh, you can't say that. What is the most underrated rock group of all time? It's a great poll, if I say so myself. We got 236 votes, even though we've only been on about 2 minutes. Holly's 39. What did I tell you? Sublime, 35. Josh is going to go home and vote again. He's going to cheat.
Mm-hmm.
I just know it because he wants his way. You know, he's one of those stubborn little bastards that wants to get his way. See, I told you. You also told us the Padres won last night. Yesterday you told us the Cubs lost when they won 7-2. So the fact that, you know, good guy, just bad information. That's Josh. You know, he means well, but problems. That's because he works at QAM. The Kinks, 29. Steely Dan, 23. Are we out of gas? Boy, do they suck. You know, the same people like Steely Dan, I guarantee you, they like Pulp Fiction. Guaranteed.
I'm not going to argue.
No, you know what I'm talking about.
I do.
It's a state of mind.
It's
a soothe thing.
So it's not like it's a soothe thing. It's not
are you sure?
Oh, and don't forget, they put mayonnaise on their fries in Amsterdam. Jethro Tull, 17. See, they're like side by each there, Steely Dan and Jethro Tull. I told you, I don't know what you're talking about. You just like to argue, man. No wonder your wife hates you.
No, I don't like to argue.
Radiohead, 16. The Animals, 13. Damn good group. Now, what was the, don't tell me, what was the, House of the Rising Sun?
Yes.
God,
a house in New Orleans, but not for much longer.
That could be one of the great... See how this all fits in together? They're recutting it. There was a house in New Orleans.
Right.
Used to be. Radiohead, 16. Animals, 13. Doobie Brothers, 10. Thank God the Doobie Brothers starting to get a little recognition here. Sweet, 8. King Crimson, 6. Supergrass, 5. Rush, 4. Berlin, 4. Husker Du, 4. Yiskadil, Dash, however that goes.
What does Husker Du?
10cc, 4. Huh?
Huh?
Crowded House, 4. Turtles, 3. Marshall Tucker Band's got 3. The Mother Tucker Band don't got any yet. Joy Division's got 3. Boy, straighten that out real quick. Thank you, Eric. I'm assuming Eric did that. Cream, 2. Band of Nomen's got 2. They got a pair.
Ow!
Oh, man, I can't believe that. Must have a couple of krauts out there. Marillion, 2. We finally got that right. Boy, did Eric straighten these out?
Yeah, well, we got to tell him.
He must have eaten several meals today to be in this good of a mood. Crazy Horse, 2. Grand Funk Railroad, 1. Frankie Lyman of the Teenagers, that guy got around when he's got 1. Daddy War's Hole has got 1. And none yet for XTC, Talking Heads, and NRBQ, which just popped up on there.
Stern Show, Neil Rogers, mornings and midday, and sports around the clock, 560 QAM.
Buck it in and hold it.
Hi, I'm Joey D., formerly of Joey D. and the Starlighters. I'm also founder of the Rock and Roll Rest Home, where we provide care and treatment for many of the rock and roll stars you've loved so much in the past, but whose lives have been destroyed by crooked record companies. Stars like Mr. D. Clark over here. You can plainly see why we need your help. Over here we have Danny Lupitas, who sang rhythm for the Gavones. Every now and then I try to help him out. It's okay, Danny. It's okay, calm down. I will help you.
I wonder why I love you like I do.
Please show your support by sending your checks to 442 Glenwood Avenue in Surf City. Our email address is brunswick.swan. For more information, just call Beechwood 45789. Thank you.
Call 18 at 560 WQM. Don't forget to join George and little bald-headed Boca Brian, old chicken neck today, from 5 to 7 at Happy Hour Treasure Island, located just off the Palmetto, just north of the 122nd Street exit. This week's feature will be Stephanie Evans. That's at 5 this afternoon. And when you're there, George will tell you all about that other place. Won't you?
Sure, why not?
Oh, here's one. Oh, no. Did you hear that?
I think, yeah, everybody did.
No, they didn't. They just thought they were skipping and jumping. Well, see, I mean, they really don't qualify, and they got a tremendous number of hits. I can't think of any other ones. I just wanted an excuse to play that song, and it goes to show I'm being punished by God. Because it, what was that all about? I bet you somebody munged on the CD, you know?
Probably got pizza cheese on there.
Oh, man, I bet you Jeff Cohen done it. Now, I don't see any marks, any tracks, at any rate. Speaking of crowded house.
Somewhere deep inside, something's got a hold on you. And it's pushing me aside.
Oh, and speaking of other groups that I can't even find out what cut this is on here, that nobody has mentioned, and we're really glad they didn't.
Yeah, they're rated just fine. Right where they should be.
Yeah. At any rate, yeah, no, I don't have the Zombies. Somebody says the Zombies. That's a good. She's not there. I do have a Gregory in Coral Springs. She's not there somewhere. Probably there in the studio. Here, I don't have like a whole bunch of music. I've got, you know, a few here and there. It's amazing how many that I do have. You know.
I looked for it, but it's not there.
She's not. It's not there. Well, too bad. Zombies. Good group. Hollies are still hanging on to a lead. In fact, look at the Kinks have got right now.
About 30, man.
They might just blow right on by. Okay. I'm not really sure that they ought to be on there. Paul Waldman writes, "Girly man, George W. Bush is a coward."
Absolutely correct, sir.
He's strong, he's resolute, he looks evildoers in the eye and doesn't blink. He's our national daddy, standing in the doorway with a righteous six-gun and a steely gaze, not Steely Dan, a steely gaze, striking fear into the hearts of all who would do us harm. By God, George W. Bush is a real man. Or is he? We certainly know that Bush wants us to believe he's a real man. In fact, there are a few things that he works harder at. Sometimes it seems as if the entire might of the U.S. government is being wielded for the purpose of creating photo ops where Bush can look manly. We saw plenty of examples at the Republican convention. The video introducing Bush, narrated with the profound vocal stylings of actor-politician Fred Thompson, begins this way. How do you tell the story of a presidency? How do you tell the story so far? The story is in part but inescapably the story of a man. Despite being billed as a biography, the video told virtually nothing about what Bush has actually done in the last 4 years, let alone his life up to that point. Instead, it was mostly about Bush's 9/11-related moments of theater. For the umpteenth time, we saw Bush vowing revenge through a bullhorn at Ground Zero, then Bush being photographed visiting soldiers in the hospital. The film ends with an extended retelling of Bush going to Yankee Stadium and throwing out the first ball at a World Series game not long after 9/11, presented with swelling music and slow motion, as though his ability to walk to the mound and throw the ball was some act of extraordinary heroism of which no mere mortal would have been capable. And in his convention speech, Bush reemphasized his masculinity. So, see, even he is Butch, see? Even I'm catching on to it. Some folks look at me and see a certain swagger, he said, which in Texas is called walking. There's certainly a swagger in Bush's walk, but what is most notable is how affected it is. It's not about being strong, it's about looking strong. New York Times columnist Frank Rich recently noted that castration warfare has been a Republican staple ever since Michael Dukakis provided the opening by dressing up like Snoopy to ride a tank. Democrats are understandably frustrated that Bush has been so successful at painting John Kerry as the one possessed of insufficient testosterone, down to calling his Vietnam service into question. After all, when their country called them to go into harm's way, Kerry said, where do I sign? While Bush said, how do I get out of this? Vietnam was hardly the last time Bush would show himself to be something of a sissy boy. In fact, when you begin to think about history, an unmistakable picture emerges. George W. Bush is a coward. I don't use the word lightly. Speaking as someone born too late to be drafted, I can't say whether I would have been brave enough to follow John Kerry's course into Vietnam, but Bush's cowardice doesn't only emerge when his physical safety is at stake, although he's quite happy to proclaim his courageous indifference to dangers that will be faced by others, i.e. bring them on. Let's look at some other cases. When Bush was told that America was under attack by terrorists, he froze like a deer in the headlights, sitting there listening to my pet goat for 7 interminable minutes before someone came and told him it was okay for him to get up and start doing something presidential. Ask a Bush partisan about this, and their spinning will generate enough centrifugal force to suck in anything in the room that isn't bolted down. He was trying to reassure the children, they'll say, and project strength. When Ari Fleischer held up a sign that read, "Don't say anything yet," a real man would not have complied as Bush did. A real man would have stood up and said, "It's been wonderful to meet you, children, but I have to go," and gone to check on the status of the country he was supposed to be leading. When the 9/11 Commission wanted to question the president, he ran like a little girl who just saw a spider. First he said he wouldn't testify, then he said he would talk to them, but not under oath, and only for an hour. Finally he agreed, but only so long as no one recorded the session, and Dick Cheney came along to bail him out if things got uncomfortable. These weren't just the actions of a man who had something to hide. They were the actions of a man afraid to answer for what he did and didn't do. And what kind of a wimp can't be questioned about without his vice president by his side? Bush has held only 12 solo press conferences in his presidency, fewer than any other modern president, and you can rest assured there won't be another one between now and November. A real man would take questions from the press, even if some of them are going to be confrontational. At his last disastrous press conference, Bush couldn't bring himself to admit to a single mistake he's made in office. Real men admit it when they're wrong. No undecided voters, let alone Democrats, are allowed into Bush campaign events lest the farcical Ask the President events include a question that isn't accompanied by a fulsome praise of Bush's greatness. A real man would have the guts to encounter voters who don't already love him. Bush's representatives are now pushing to eliminate from the schedule of debates the town hall scheduled to take place in St. Louis. According to news reports, they're concerned that, though the audience is supposed to consist of undecided voters, a Kerry supporter might sneak in and get to ask a question. What kind of wimp is scared of answering a question from someone who supports his opponent? After all, Bush is supposed to be the president of all Americans, not just those who support him. But he doesn't seem to have the guts to look the voters in the eye. Since September 11th, polls have shown President Bush rating especially high in whether voters perceive him to be a strong leader. And there's no doubt that Bush knows how to appear strong, put him in a flag suit or cowboy outfit, and he's in seventh heaven. The frontier justice catchphrases will tumble from his lips, dead or alive, smoke him out, get him running. But when it comes time to actually demonstrate strength, Bush withers and fades. And, of course, he was a cheerleader in high school. How girly is that? Pretty good stuff, huh? He's a girly man, El Presidente, a real girly man, a coward, a wimp, a draft-dodging piece of crap. Some little piece of good news here. New poll shows the Bush bounce fading just when we were getting ready to kill ourselves. More than a week after the Republican National Convention and in the wake of new questions about Bush's National Guard service, the race for the White House is once again tightening, thank the Lord, just as pollsters and strategists for both campaigns had predicted it would. A new Monitor tip poll finds Mr. Bush and Senator John Kerry currently tied among likely voters nationwide, with each receiving 47% of the vote in a two-man race, each receiving 46% when Ralph Nader's added to the ballot. The poll was conducted September 7th through the 12th, has a margin of error of 4%. Immediately following the GOP convention, polls showed Bush would lead anywhere from 7 to 11 points, but that bounce seems to be fading, and the Bush is fading, too, as more recent polls cut his lead down to 4 or 5 points, yada, yada, yada. How do you like that?
I like it.
Well, there you go. So we got a shot. As Jimmy Johnson would say, we got a shot. And Jimmy Johnson said also, speaking of sissy boys, Ricky Williams is a piece of crap, is what he said.
You are listening to Neil Rogers, exclusively on 560 QAM.
Abu Dhar Reb.
Oh my
her
God.
Hair is hollow gold, her lips sweet surprise. Her hands are never cold. She's got Betty Davis eyes.
She's oily, soily, you know. Looks like the Quaker Oats guy. From the body roll bowls, Barbara Bush has 40,000 eyes pulled up, her eyes popped out. It happened when she realized she raised four criminal clowns. Barbara Bush has 40,000 eyes.
could be high enough that it could cut part of this peninsula off, and that's something that officials have warned people about, and that's why many of them have actually evacuated.
Not to mention the Robin Bush filthy rich fat, and smells just like the magic stars on a big hat. Barbara Bush resembles Ernest Borgnine on a bad day with Marty Perelman.
Yeah, she served in the military, old man. She was in McHale's Navy is what I'm hearing. 12:33, and isn't it great that we get a little bonus for the audience to get to hear Ricky Tikki Sanchez's voice once in a while?
They figure if they were to get the mobile
looks to me like he's going to get blown right into the Gulf.
All right.
Oh, yeah, let's have a party over that.
It's like there's no escape.
I got one for you. In fact, I got two for you, I think. What the hell did I do with the other one? Oh, here it is. Do you hear it?
Barely. Oh, here it comes.
Since you're talking about faggots, since you're upset with faggoting.
Faggoting!
This Pet Shop Boys?
Yeah. How about the Pet Shop Boys for all the maracones
sure.
out there, with or without cheese?
I like
and
them.
I got another one.
Another
See, I when you went to the Moody Blues thing, and then when I said REM, you said, oh, they're gigantic. Well, Moody Blues are gigantic too, mister.
Yeah. I didn't suggest and putting them on there.
You suggested who?
No, not them either. They're big.
How about the Guess Who?
See, I like them a lot. I think they're very underrated.
Well, there you go. And I agree with that, the Guess Who, which I got some of that over there, which I'll... And how about... Even though in South Florida, we have to tend to not be too crazy about the Foreigner.
Huh? I love them a lot.
You're as cold as ice!
Foreigner, man. Get that on there right away, Josh, or else. Kobe I Girl Silence. This is from the New York Post today. Kobe Bryant, who of course now is off the hook, at least for old time's sake, temporarily, reportedly admitted to cops that he'd take a shot at paying off the teenage hotel worker who accused him of rape. I'm in the worst effing situation, Bryant said, according to a sealed statement he made a short time before his arrest, which was obtained by Sports Illustrated. Then he told the officers he'd see if the then 19-year-old woman, who worked at the spa where he was staying in Colorado, would accept hush money, according to the statement. The superstar went on to tell cops that another NBA player routinely paid off his sex partners to keep them quiet. He added that the player, who was not identified, had paid up to $1 million to avoid situations like Bryant's. Kind of sounds like Freako one.
Michael
Bryant
Jackson.
Told cops he didn't have to pay any such bribes because he treats a woman with respect, therefore they shouldn't be saying anything, as I said, quoting the statement. The loose-lipped L.A. Laker guard rambled on to the officers as they questioned him in the hotel's parking lot the morning of July 2, 2003, 2 days after the hotel worker said he raped her. He raped it at her. He talked about how he first denied having sex with her, but then he admitted holding her, the worker, around her neck from behind before detailing the kinky acts they engaged in, according to the statement. This is from his own lips. Holding her around her neck from behind. From her behind. He insisted those acts were consensual. He also reportedly admitted cheating on his wife even before his Colorado tryst, revealing that he had engaged in a steamy affair with a girl in Virginia named Michelle. Michelle. Not Gillen, obviously. Can you even imagine that? Oh, sorry, it's in the middle of lunch hour. I apologize.
Yeah,
the L.A. Lakers star won a court victory in the rape case. Well, we know that. The civil case against him is now pending. Legal experts said they wouldn't be surprised if the two sides reach a financial settlement before it goes to trial. If it is tried in civil court, there'll be no rape shield law to prevent the 20-year-old woman's sexual history from being used against her. She could be faced with allegations of sex romps and encounters with dozens of men. Dozens.
All right.
Anything that moved, man. Lampposts, fire hydrants.
Doorknobs.
In fact, if she came up here, she'd probably get into the Royal Canadian Mounties. I bet you she ain't got nothing on Scran, though. David Gates and bread. That is sweet, ain't it?
Yeah, we can put bread on there.
I love bread.
Yeah.
You know, like
I love bread.
Bread.
You
I love
like bread.
Bread,
yeah.
Oh, I see. Chicken and kale for me. Lasagna for you. David Gates and bread. Great group. A very, very ugly guy. And, of course, very syrupy music. Not the kind of music that most of the real men in our audience like, but I like them.
No, ballads.
Yeah.
But they're fine ballads.
Let's see, DB and SC says, having finally realized that either Bush or Kerry is going to be president for the next 4 years, I've installed and well-stocked a king-sized bed to hide under. Can we put Counting Crows on the list? Well, I can't see why not. Can you?
Sure, we'll put them on there.
Yeah, they won't get any votes, but we'll certainly put them on there to make you happy.
They
so while you're under the bed,
we'll
you can be smiling
there.
About it. 5670560, pound 560 on the Verizon Wireless and Singular Wireless line, eh? Line 9, WQAM, hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Great.
Hey, for the poll, Traveling Wilburys.
There you go, Traveling Wilburys.
And one more thing, Neil.
Yes.
I think...
what did you ever do to me? WQAM, hello.
How about the Alan Parsons Project?
Excellent choice. Very, very good.
Thank you.
Then thank you. We never would have thought of that for some strange reason, even though
it crossed my mind.
And why not?
But then I forgot.
I got it here somewhere, I do believe.
I like them a lot. I have a lot of records.
Great group. 5670560, pound 560 on the Verizon Wireless and Singular Wireless line. Did Clarence or Duff or anybody come in and tell us who's going to be on the air between 2 and 2:30? Nobody told us? You crazy lunatics, you, man. And just this morning, I was screaming at that child, what kind of a radio station? We don't even know what the schedule is. Well, maybe the Mad Dog will come in for a half hour. What do you think?
No chance.
He don't come in most of the time anyway. He comes in whenever he feels like it.
Caca.
That's right. That's the way to do it, man.
All right.
Yeah. Come in for a half hour before the pregame show to warm it up. Why don't they have the crow come in? Huh?
Yeah.
He smells pretty good every once in a while. Let's have the crow come in.
5670. Oh. 8560.
See, the best part of that dropping is that even he's laughing at it. Even he knows what a bozo he is. That's the best part. He's kind of like cracking himself
up. He does have a sense of humor about himself.
He sure does. And he smells like lilacs, like a French whorehouse. WQAM, hello.
What about the Spinners?
The Spinners, all right. Excellent. Love the Spinners, all right. Don't you love the Spinners?
I do love the Spinners.
See, now we probably aren't going to get too much like into the Motown groups, the Four Tops, the Spinners. The Isley Brothers?
Yeah.
How about the Isley Brothers, man?
Yeah, they won't get any votes, but yeah.
Twist and Shout, the Beatles. You know, now I begin to understand why the Beatles met a wicked end, the three of them anyway. Two of them died. Ringo Starr still looks like that. And, of course, Paul McCartney, he's the only one that's got anything going and not much. Plus that pain-in-the-ass wife.
No.
Right?
Peg leg.
Yeah. At any rate, now that was bad. Poor George Harrison. I like George Harrison. He was okay. Mm-hmm. I got my mind set on hearing that song again sometime. I think the reason I like that song so much is because I played it on Zeta, man. That was a great year on Zeta. The morning was fantastic with your friend the Bird and old Captain Dave. That was fun. Until, of course, Petey Bulger made it like hell. And then, of course, Tim Williams, who, just happened to be the son-in-law of the owner of the radio station, became General Mangler. Nice going, Tim, and you still are an idiot, baby. You are a moron. You are a simpleton. You are pathetic. You were pathetic then, and you're still, I'm sure, pathetic now, if you're still alive. Wouldn't that be something if, like, some of the people in this business that you just hated like poison?
There we go.
Yeah.
Thought I had it in the car.
Rubber Band Man, is that what you're playing?
Yeah.
All right.
Not that that's all I got.
I don't think we can say rubber anymore.
No.
Call Joyce and find out. Ask Gru Ann. She's probably got a few laying around on her desk.
This is all I got in here.
Oh! I'm gonna laugh at you!
Are you gonna talk it up?
I'm not gonna talk up I'll Be There by the Spinners. At all. I think. Where does it start? Oh. Now, that starts like in between beats, man. There's no way to talk that baby up. I never even tried that one before. At any rate, it's 20 before 1. Man, this thing is just flying by. You see, there are some benefits to having Stern go on and on and on and on. And the only bad thing is we got no early ball game today. We do have that game at 10:30. Right?
You're asking me?
Now, why did I write down Elke? Oh, that's right. Elke Summer is the beaded curtain today. That's a fine picture, in case you haven't perused that.
That's a damn good picture. Nice.
Taking a peek at good old Elke.
You are listening to Neil Rogers exclusively on 560 QAM.
It's Dave in Miami Town.
Yes.
At 560 WQAM.
Dude, man, nobody likes to get up in the morning. But let's face it, party all night, sleep all day makes Johnny one unemployed convenience store worker. That's why you need the Rock and Roll Alarm Clock. No wimpy beep beeps here. Just gut-wrenching, high decibel screams from today's top rock artists. You'll awake to Bruce Springsteen and Joe Cocker. Chris Robinson from the Black Crowes. And for the true comatose snooze hound, there's the Who Alarm. If that doesn't wake you up, call the morgue. You're a warm food, man. Studies show stoked brains respond to the Rock and Roll Alarm Clock. Get it now and headbang your way into a new day. Yeah.
I'm dying over here.
1245 at 560. Somebody faxes and says the Dave Clark Five. They were pretty good.
Okay.
You don't like the Dave Clark Five?
No, they're just fine. We'll stick them on there.
Yeah, stick them on there. I mean, of the British invasion groups, of which how many were there?
About 30, man.
About 30,000. They were one of the better ones, Dave Clark Five. They had some big, but again, that's for us old fogies like me. And since we're talking about... Guess who this is?
How many guesses do I get?
Have you been around? Have you done your share of coming down?
I think last year when we had the whole SARS thing going on here in Toronto, and I mentioned they did that free concert with 500,000 people who showed up. And Burton Cummins came in with a guess who, and they kind of like reunited, and it was very embarrassing. He sounded terrible. I was just couldn't believe it. I mean, I could say it was great. They had it on TV, and oh, man, you kidding me? I could have said, I love Burton Cummins. I love the guess who. I might be one of their biggest all-time fans, okay, but they sounded really bad. Group offers $50,000 for proof of Bush service. The founder of the group Texans for Truth said yesterday that he's offering $50,000 to anyone who can prove that President Bush fulfilled his service requirements, including required duties and drills, in the Alabama Air National Guard in 1972. And, of course, we're all wondering why he wouldn't take that physical, you know it?
Right.
You don't think it could have been because of those problems that he had during his youthful indiscretion days, do you? That
what,
he don't seem to
problem?
Want to talk about anymore? When he was really young, you know, like 40? The group, well, maybe 30. I would say...
About 30, man!
The group made the announcement as Bush was in Las Vegas to address the National Guard Association's convention. Today would be a fine day for him to finally have to answer all the questions that we have dogged that have dogged him since he entered public life, the group's founder Glenn Smith said in a statement. Bush's dishonesty about missing from service during Vietnam goes to the heart of his presidency. He was dishonest then, just as he's misleading us about why we went to war with Iraq, he said. He dodges responsibility then, just as he dodges responsibility for Iraq today. White House Communication Director Dan Bartlett has said that the fact that Bush received an honorable discharge means he fulfilled his military duties. Bartlett has dismissed questions about Bush's service as partisan attacks. In other words, don't confuse us with the truth. Smith said the controversy about whether documents obtained by CBS News alleging the future president failed to obey an order to undergo a physical exam and failed to complete his service in the Alabama Air National Guard was irrelevant. Authentic or not, they don't really answer the question about where Mr. Bush was when he was supposed to be doing his duty in the National Guard, he said. And, of course, he is...
Absolutely correct, sir.
On Monday, First Lady Laura Bush said she believed such documents were probably forgeries. You know, they probably are altered, and they probably are forgeries, and I think that's terrible, really, she said in an interview with Radio Iowa, that syrupy bitch said. Oh, pretty tough on the First Lady, huh, Neil? That's actually one of the risks you take when you run for public office or when you're in the public eye for any reason. That's obviously a lot of things are said about you that aren't true, and that's the drawback. That's the one thing that's not great about serving in public office, he said. She said. He said, she said. CBS News has said it stands by its story and will continue to report on it. White House Press Secretary Scott McClellan said yesterday the president has seen the documents and has no recollection of any of them. He has convenient Alzheimer's, just like Reagan had. And then, of course, God punished him and gave him the real thing. White House spokeswoman Claire Buchan said the First Lady's comments do not mean the White House has done an investigation into the authenticity of the documents, but that news organizations' probes have raised questions about whether the documents are real and it's a good scam. CBS reported that the memos were written in 72 and 73 by Colonel Jerry Killing. We know that. Yada, yada, yada. We know all this other stuff in here. Right?
Right.
He's a coward. He's a draft dodger. And the fact that he's attacking a decorated war veteran who have enlisted and served his country proudly and well, volunteered to serve while others were running off to places like Canada, eh? While other people were finding all kinds of excuses to dodge the draft and drop the dodge, like Bill Clinton, for example, and like Dick Cheney, no less. Dick Cheney, 5 deferments, no less. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Huh?
Yeah.
Count them. How do we count the ways that these neocons dodge the draft? See, I can't even say that.
Careful.
I'm tongue-tied. Well, it's because of this story here. A couple arrested in Charleston, West Virginia for wearing anti-Bush T-shirts to a July 4th presidential appearance. Zion America, baby! Filed a federal lawsuit yesterday alleging their First Amendment rights were violated. Arrested for wearing anti-Bush T-shirts to a July 4th presidential appearance. Hitler would be proud and Hermann Göring would be beaming from ear to ear. Nicole and Jeff Rank were removed from the event at the West Virginia Capitol in handcuffs after revealing T-shirt with President Bush's name crossed out on the front. Nicole Rank's shirt had the words Love America, Hate Bush on the back, and Jeff Rank's said regime change starts at home. Regime. Their lawsuit was filed in federal court by the ACLU attorneys. What is at stake here transcends politics, Jeff Rank said at a news conference at the Capitol, and this whole story really is pretty rank, if you ask me. What is at stake is the right of all Americans, Democrats, Republicans, Independents, all Americans, to peacefully voice their dissent to their government, wearing T-shirts.
Mm-hmm. Without any potty sayings on them, even?
No, I just got through reading what it said on them.
Right.
Not even anything that Joyce would make us bleep off the air. How do you like that?
Caca.
They didn't even have to take the dump button fairy with them. Trespassing charges filed against the couple were later dismissed. The city council and Mayor Danny Jones have publicly apologized. How do you like that? The lawsuit names Gregory Jenkins, deputy assistant to the president and director of the White House Office of Presidential Advance, and W. Ralph Basham, director of the U.S. Secret Service, as defendants. He saw him and he wanted to bash him. The couple wants the judge to declare unconstitutional any policy that led to their arrest. They're also seeking unspecified monetary damages. Maybe a few million would be good.
About 30, man.
Yeah, for a start. We'll take, we want about half.
Okay, that'll do.
10 for me, 3 for you, 2 for Josh. He's a punk. Spokesman for the Secret Service and U.S. Department of Justice, to whom a White House spokesman directed question, declined to comment. Both said their agencies don't comment on ongoing litigation. The ACLU filed a federal lawsuit in September last year against the Secret Service, seeking an injunction against the Bush administration for segregating protesters at his public appearances. The Secret Service had to agree to stop the practices. Jeff Rank, 29, said he and his wife wore the T-shirts because when you see the president speak on TV, he's usually shown surrounded by fervent supporters only. While we wanted to hear him out and while we wanted to see him in person, we didn't want to be added to the tally of Bush supporters that day. Nicole Rank, 30.
About 30, man.
Initially was dismissed from her job with FEMA, but was rehired after the charges were dropped. How do you like this communist bunch of crap? These Nazis, these fascists, these goose-stepping lunatics that have taken power in America by stealing the election. And by taking away every single right they can, piece by piece, turning the Constitution to tatters. God, here's one from German who says, no, he's not a German, that's his name. Maybe his name is German. German Titov. Remember German Titov?
No.
Oh. Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes and their song, Wake Up Everybody, should be the Kerry campaign theme song. You want to put Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes on there?
No, not really.
I don't either. I mean, yeah, wake up. It's time for Kerry and his people to wake up. No question about that. In fact, who was it that ripped him an ass? I got that story here somewhere. Here it is. Longtime Democratic insider Tony Coelho lashed out at the Kerry presidential campaign, characterizing it as a campaign in chaos. It's kind of like QAM. I see tremendous similarities there, don't you?
Yep.
That's right. With yet another appointment of a former Clinton administration staffer to Kerry's team on Tuesday, Coelho argues the problem is worsening, not getting better. There is nobody in charge. Now, listen to the comparisons with what's going on at QAM, okay? There is nobody in charge, and you have these two teams that are generally not talking to each other, says Coelho, who ran Al Gore's campaign early in the 2000 presidential race. As Coelho and other detractors see it, there is a civil war within the Kerry campaign, just like there is at QAM. A war between the sports nerds and those of us who are not part of the sports nerd fraternity. Senator Ted Kennedy's former chief staff members, Mary Beth Cahill, the Kerry campaign manager, and veteran Democrat strategist Bob Shrum, a real loser, are at odds with recent additions who served under President Clinton. Here are two groups that have never gotten along and have fought, and it's a lot over money, said Coelho, because in the Democratic Party, the consultants get paid for the creation and the placement of advertising. Republicans only pay you for the creation, not the placement. Coelho, a former congressman who served as House Majority Whip for the Democrats from 87 to 89, does not question any of Kerry's staff's sincerity in wanting to unseat President Bush, but his comments highlight a long-standing battle within the party for national campaign control. In 88, Dukakis, Shrum is involved. In 92, Clinton, nothing to do with Shrum. They don't want Shrum in any way, Coelho says. In 96, they don't want Shrum in any way. In 2000, Gore doesn't want the Clinton people. We go forward, 2004, all of a sudden it's the Shrum-Kennedy people. And Coelho adds that the Kerry campaign staffers are in serious trouble now, so now they want to bring in the Clinton people. The Democratic scuttlebutt has long been filled with concern over Shrum's losing streak. He remains 0-7 in presidential elections, from George McGovern to Michael Dukakis to Al Gore. from Tinker to average. But Sweet has got 10. Everybody else in single digits so far.
You're listening to Neil Rogers exclusively on 560 QAM.
Hello, this is Delarice, and you know who. Mama be listening to her angel Neil Rogers on 1-2-Hour.
In that power company on hold.
You put the futility in utility, Florida paradise and light. There isn't a hurricane that blows as much as you.
And you really don't.
When a storm threatens, we can count on you to turn our power off long before it gets here, leaving the rest of us to marvel at the blue glow of exploding transformers, providing us a historical perspective of 1957 technology. And in the moist heat of tropical darkness, the weakening batteries in our radios broadcast your latest press release for South Florida that says your trucks and crews are ready to roll from the Alabama state border. And the question in everyone's mind is, huh? So as we search for the appropriate answer to how many FPL emergency crews does it take to change a light bulb, Florida Paradise and Light, this bird's for you.
Net Power Company, Mongoose.
Absolutely correct, sir.
Okay, that's too a little out of you. Let off some steam. Let you vent. Those of you who are pissed off and fired up waiting for days and weeks and months for them to finally get around to getting your power back on. And, of course, by the time they do that, the next big blow is coming along. I've been remiss. We ought to take about 100 calls this hour, at least 200, 300, 400.
Okay.
Because I'm sure there are many, many more names we need to get on this poll. I just thought that maybe some of them stories were worth getting on.
I like them.
Did you?
Always.
567. I'm sure Miguel didn't like him. He hates that. Boy, he just can't stand that stuff.
Oh, he likes them a lot better than adding names to the poll, I'm sure.
Too bad. Like I said, let's get 700 or 800 names added on that poll this hour. And I think he ought to pay that price as kind of penance for not knowing anything about the geography of Cuba. Last time that we were talking, oh, man, that was so embarrassing. He's telling me Guantanamo Bay is in the western tip. They're the ones that are going to get hit by that hurricane, by Ivan.
All he knew was on A-tip.
Man, all he knows about is like guayaberas and beans. That's basically it. Has beans.
But you enjoyed the beans.
WQAM, hello. Don't talk about beans. Joyce will get upset, okay? WQAM, hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How about Screw Ann and the Pole Smokers?
Hi,
buddy. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil, how are you?
Okay.
How about the Smiths?
The Smiths?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, not bad. We can handle it. Thanks, Pally. See ya. How about the Smiths?
Right, we're adding it.
Buffalo Bob Smith?
Mm-hmm.
WQAM, hello.
What about the Ramones?
What about them? I think, isn't he dead?
Yes, Joey.
He's dead. I knew that. I just kind of a rhetorical question. We can put the Ramones on there. There we got some Ramone fans out there. Maybe.
About 30, man.
Sure, why the hell not? Don't you think?
Sure, why not?
WQAM, hello. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Supertramp.
Excellent. That is maybe one of the best ideas of the whole day. Thank you so much.
Have a good one.
And you too. One. Supertramp. Oh, as a matter of fact, see, it's amazing with the very teeny tiny, and I wouldn't say library would be quite, you know, an exaggeration here, that I have here in my beautiful studio that works so well. But just amazing that almost every time something comes up, and I'm stalling because this thing doesn't seem to want to work.
Right.
Huh?
Bitch better have my money.
Oh.
We're back.
Oh, hey, this is from
you.
Yeah.
Oh,
little,
there you
little
go.
Extra clip from Magnolia there. Oh, that gun is falling. Oh, jeez. Right in through the TV.
It was early morning yesterday. I was up before the dawn.
I think this is the best song of all time, if you ask me. This moment.
And I really have enjoyed
Don't you?
I like it a lot.
But I must be moving on.
Oh, I found the Alan Parsons, by the way. Thanks
for
the same, Eric.
Like a king without a castle. Like a queen without a throne. I'm a dirty morning lover. And I must be moving on.
I'll tell you what else I like a lot, although she's not a group, but it just happens to be on here.
Amy Benz.
A movie that you really ought to like a lot more than you do. And it's just, I don't want to hear anything about the ending. I don't want to hear any excuses. There's nothing negative about Magnolia, man. Jason Robards is turning over in his grave. Thinking
you
what you said.
Look like...
That song is so morbid, so perfect for that movie. It's great. It is depressing. It's morbid and it's very long. So if you feel suicidal, if the hurricanes have got you really depressed. Oh, here's the best record of all
wish
time.
Wish I had some level on this computer here.
Too bad. It's okay. No, it's not okay.
I know. I'd tell somebody about it, but you know how that goes.
Yeah, they don't care. They hate us like poison. Too bad the feeling is mutual, okay, as they used to say on the radio network where Larry King used to work before he became a big butt-sucking expert. WQAM, hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
How about Frank Marino, Mahogany Rush?
What is it?
Frank Marino, Mahogany Rush. And the guess who?
We got the guess who. Frank Marino, Mahogany Rush.
I'm
what
trying to think,
that?
Is that a joke suggestion? Because I've never heard of any of that.
No. WQAM, hello.
Can I be on the poll?
Yeah, we'd like to stick your ass in the pool, I'll tell you that right now, okay? In fact, we'd like to see the top of it come right up through your skull where your brain used to be. That'd be great. WQAM, hello.
Neil, how about the Fantastic Two?
The what?
The Fantastic Two, the look.
Yeah. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yeah.
A couple things. For those who love Marshall Tucker, I hear they're playing in Homestead, rain, shine, or hurricane this weekend.
Yeah.
Also, my choice for the poll is the Late Night Band when Bill Clinton was guest saxophonist. Very underrated.
Yeah, there you go. Okay. I think they're out of material. I don't think maybe Miguel lucked out. They don't have any more names for the poll. I thought there'd be like thousands.
About 30, man.
Of people they wanted to put in the poll. Wouldn't you?
I would have thought. Maybe
but they're more interested in showing us their pimply ass than they are in giving us any name, which is fine. Okay, we only got, but we do have all the way till 2 o'clock today, which is excellent. So we probably could look at a lot of ass in that hour. WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I have nothing to say. I just want to hear Supertramp again.
Oh. Oh, man. Wait, you know, his wish is my command. I just love Supertramp.
No, they're great.
See, and to me, I mean, there are a lot of these like R.E.M. and Moody Blues. They don't really belong on there. They're not, but we put them on because make you people happy, you know. But I mean, Supertramp. If you were to ask, what are the top 10, 20 groups? Who the hell would say Supertramp? You know, right?
When I was young, it seemed that life was so wonderful.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, that's enough. I'd like to play the whole soundtrack. In fact, why don't we just play the audio from Magnolia for the rest of the week?
I never got tired of that song.
How could you get tired of that song? First of all, when do they play it? Does Magic play
What? I have no
Supertramp?
Idea. I gave up on
Oh,
South
come
Florida
on,
radio,
man. Don't tell me
like
you don't listen to Tragic 102.7 and our good friend, our good capped friend, Ricky Tikki Shaw.
What would be the point?
What would be the point is that you can hear Build Me Up Buttercup by the Foundations and the Righteous Brothers 40, 50 times every day.
I'm good.
What's wrong with that?
I got that
What
down.
Not to like?
Yeah.
5670560, pound 560 on the Verizon Wireless Cellular Wireless Line, singular. What'd I say? Singular Wireless. Don't forget, join George and Boca Bryan today.
And Miguel.
5 to 7. And Miguel will be there, too. He might get a little extra on the side. 5 to 7 during happy hour at Treasure Island, located right off the Palmetto, just north of the 122nd Street exit. This week's feature will be Stephanie Evans. Is she kin to, like, Dale Evans?
They got a similar act, yeah.
I heard they kind of horsed around together is what I heard. That's at 5 this afternoon.
They're both straight shooters.
WQAM, hello. Kind of like Peter North. Yes?
Let's keep the Supertramp coming. How about Dreamer?
Dreamer?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
Put him in a vice to sing along with that one.
WQAM, hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good. Yes.
How about 10 years after?
Yeah, how about 10 years after?
Pardon?
In fact, I said great idea. Call me in about 10. 5670560, pound 560, Verizon Wireless, Singular Wireless Line. WQAM, hello.
How about Buddha
yes,
Gonzalez and the Headless Chihuahuas?
WQAM, hello.
Yeah, who's this?
Who are you calling?
WQAM.
This is WQAM, sir, your confused radio station for the new millennium. What can we do for you?
Neil's asking about bands.
Underrated.
What do you mean?
The most underrated band. That's the name of the pool. That's it.
Rare Earth.
Rare Earth. Okay, there we go. We finally got around to it. Okay, but what do you mean? Well, no, I mean, what do you mean?
What do you mean?
Underrated. Well, there's, look at that. There's, what's her name?
What's her name?
Bill Hummer there on the beach ready to get blown away. See, they just can't stop. They had that broad on there, that Lucia Newman again today. That outfit she was wearing, that poncho. She's the honcho with the poncho, just getting torn to tatters as she's like hanging on for dear life. I'm telling you, the day is going to come that one of these bastards is going to get blown into the water, the Gulf, the ocean, somewhere, and it's going to be bye-bye.
Well, that's
what a shame
it'd
be left for like this Ricky Ticky Sanchez. Oh, God. You think that when the Marlins won, there were celebrations in South Florida. You ain't seen nothing yet. And speaking of sports, don't forget, no hockey season. You can say goodbye, kiss the Panthers goodbye, at least for a long, long time. So if Alan Cohen or any of those goyim in the organization and Yidlach as well, like him, want your money, just tell them, forget about it. Right? Oh, right. And look at that.
They're just changed dramatically over the course of the last hour or so. And we received a report not long ago, that not here, we don't want to alarm anyone, but about 200 to 300 miles offshore, they have registered one wave in excess of 34 feet. So you can imagine
that type of storm,
Category 4 storm, would bring with it. You heard Bill mention moments ago the 68 people who've perished in the Caribbean, in the Grenada area, and also in Jamaica. Grenada, by the way, they still have 90% of the homes that have been damaged as a result of this storm.
Why is he on there? What is the purpose? Well, I know he needs a job, but what is he doing on there? Is he going to be the CNN hysteria specialist? Is that it?
Hey, he's got to do something.
12 minutes after 1 at 5:60, and I'm sure that by now Clarence has come in to give us an update on the 2 to 2:30 schedule, ain't he?
Yeah. Oh, I mean, no.
Stay tuned.
You're listening to Neil Rogers exclusively on 560
QAM. Oh, my God, your breasts are beautiful.
Here's what people are saying about the SimuSlim diet.
The SimuSlim ad showed a blurry before picture of this fat lady in a bulky sweater. And in the after picture, she's turned sideways and sucking in her stomach. I thought, it's got to be a scam.
It is a scam. But unlike other scam diets, the SimuSlim diet actually simulates the appearance of weight loss.
Since I tried the SimuSlim diet, people tell me I look great, as long as I'm turning sideways and sucking in my gut.
And the SimuSlim diet is perfect for men, too.
I look like I've lost 40 pounds on the SimuSlim diet. I'm also turning blue.
Don't go to the trouble of actually losing weight. Just look thin with SimuSlim.
117 at 560 WQAM. Martha, ready to do time. You ready for that?
Yeah, I'm ready for it. I wonder if she is.
Martha Stewart said today she'll start serving her 5-month prison sentence as soon as possible in order to put her nightmare behind her behind. The homemaking expert entrepreneur said the decision was hard but necessary one for her to get on with her life and her business, and that she was anxious to get back to work as soon as she could. The best word to use for this very hard and difficult decision is finality, and my intense desire to put this nightmare behind my behind, both personally and professionally, Stewart 63 said at a news conference this morning at Martha Stewart Living Omnimedia headquarters in Manhattan. I must reclaim my good life, and I must return to my good works. What are those?
Bath mats.
Dressed in khaki garb and at times emotional, Stewart called the prospect of going to prison and giving up her freedom frightening and difficult. Oh, she ain't seen nothing yet. Wait till them big mamas in there get a hold of that bitch. Stewart was sentenced in July to 5 months prison and 5 months of house arrest. Well, we know that. Like Eric Idle says, she's an uppity rich bitch, and stick her ass in there. WQAM, hello.
Uncle Neil.
Yes, sir.
One for the poll, two if I can do it.
One.
Okay. Little Feet, Bad Fingers.
Little Feet. Oh, my God. I'm so sorry you said that.
I know.
Okay,
yeah, I know you don't like them.
Quit while you're behind. Thanks. Oh, Little Feet. Man. The only thing I can't stand worse than Little Feet is Smelly Feet. This whole thing with smelly people, I don't know why that is. Now, they say that as you get older, certain senses get weaker and other ones get stronger. Maybe my sense
is that
of
what they say?
Smell. Huh?
Maybe. Is that why the old people are always complaining about things they smell?
About their toe jam?
But they smell bad. Like,
yeah, and you notice that the ones that wear a bag, they don't seem to be able to smell it.
Right.
And you were trying to give me this song and dance about how people can't smell their own bad odor. I just
acclimated.
I don't understand it.
Trust me.
Why? How?
Because that's how smell works.
If someone smeared 2 pounds of elephant crap all over you, you'd smell it.
After a certain point, you would not.
So in other words, if you just walked around and didn't wash it off after a few days, it would be just like a party.
There you go.
Well, man, there must be an awful lot of people running around with elephant crap smeared on them because, God,
yeah, don't say
they smell like crap.
Yeah.
I've always said if you can't look good, and a lot of us never will and never did, at least smell good.
Right.
You know, that makes it a little more pleasant to be around, you know.
Well, then people like the crow are going to complain. See, he wants me to smell good. I put raspberry
but not too
there.
Good, okay? In other words, find a happy medium, okay? Call up Mickey Dane and she'll give you some instruction.
Complain about that.
I'm smelling decent, but not too good. Not like lilacs. Not like you took a bath in cashmere bouquet and about 400 pounds of it. God.
Yeah, wash it off.
WQAM, hello.
Neil God.
Yes, sir.
One group and then one idea for the poll.
Yeah.
How about the Bee Gees?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Yeah. I do love that one.
Yeah.
And do Americans think that we could get by without illegal Mexican help?
Yeah, there you go. Good question. Excellent. Do we think we can get by without illegal Mexican help? Let's ask some of the Beaners what they think. 567-0560, pound 560. This is great because it shows that after this hurricane thing, we had a lot of people there who were kind of like out of touch and no electric and kind of like lost trying to put their lives together, their business back together. But this is a good sign because every tutti frutti, every nut job in the audience is out there now, and that's good to hear. Right? Don't you feel better about life?
Oh, yeah. Every day.
You bet. WQAM, hello. Not there. WQAM, hola.
Hola.
Hello.
Hello, yes.
Yes, sir.
Speak to Neil, please.
Speaking.
Oh, Neil, thank God. A Beaner's calling you. Can you get rid of all the ass lickers? And I love you, Neil.
WQAM, hello.
How about the group? Nugget, nugget.
WQAM, hello.
Hey, Neil, how about
yes,
how about the Butthole Surfers? Can you put them on your phone?
Yeah, okay. WQAM, hello.
I think it was serious.
Good morning, Neil. How you doing?
Yes, sir. Good.
A band for your poll, Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention.
Hey, that's good. As a matter of fact, I'm so impressed that he said that. Now, let's see. Did I try playing this before? I think I was able to play it. I had like...
give it a shot.
Huh?
Hey there, people, I'm Bobby
we'll give it a try.
Brown. They say I'm the cutest boy in town. My car is fast. My teeth are shiny. I tell all the girls they can kiss my hiney. Here I am at a famous school. I'm dressing sharp and I'm acting cool. I got a cheerleader here who wants to help with my paper. Better do all the work and maybe later I'll read the roll. Oh God, I am the American dream. I do not think I'm too extreme and I'm a handsome son of a bitch.
Now, I'm thinking, I'm stopping it right there, because I'm not so sure there's anything in here that we do dump out.
I bleeped it. It's already pre-bleeped. I think it's clean.
Are you sure?
No,
well, let's give it a
sure.
shot.
Women's liberation came creeping all across the nation.
Here it comes.
I tell you people, I was not ready when I fought this dyke by the name of Freddie. She made a little speech then, all she tried to make you say when.
This part
she had the balls in her vice, but she left the dick. I guess it's still hooked on, but now it's you.
Okay.
Wait, I need closure.
Oh, yeah.
How does the story end?
Well, I had one dump button. I used mine. I don't know about anybody else, but it was all right.
It's a love song. Why can't we play
yeah,
that?
You did one hell of a good job on bleeping that one up. Nice. Excellent. Man, in fact, I think you did such a good job that you'll be sitting right on Duff's lap the next several months in there in the morning when Stern is on, just to make sure we get everything out. Wow. WQAM, hello.
Hello, QAM?
Yes, sir.
I got a group for you there.
Yeah.
They're out of California. They're called Love.
Well,
L-O-V-E. Nobody
L-O-V-E.
Loves both of them. But they
sounds
didn't.
Pretty boring to me. Okay. You love Love?
No. Never heard of Love.
Okay. Neither did I. WQAM, hello.
For the poll?
Yes, sir.
NRBQ?
It's on there.
NRBQ. They're already on there. Thank you. Already on there, ain't they?
Yes.
I should probably give the results on the poll, but we're too busy yakking it up here about poor Frank Zappa, who's still dead. What is the most underrated rock group of all time? I'm sure as hell never doing this again anytime soon. I thought it was going to be great, but 467 votes. Sublime, 50. Hollies, 45. The Kinks, 43. We got a nice race going on here. Mm-hmm. And also still within shooting distance, Steely Dan. And, of course, if anybody deserved to be shot.
Well, maybe they'll run out of gas.
Yeah, maybe just shoot the gas tank, and then they will run out of gas. You're right. Jethro Tull has got, look what he's got.
About 30, man.
Rush, 29. The Doobie Brothers, 26. Radiohead, 25. But we got a lot of names on this list, don't we? The Animals, 20. And, again, they don't really belong on that list, but that's all right. Cream, 15. King Crimson, 12. Sweet, 11. How's he doing, by the way, Frills? Is he still alive?
As far as I know.
Talking Heads, 9. The Pet Shop Boys, 8. Crowded House, 8. Grand Funk Railroad, 7. Marshall Tucker Band, 7. Berlin, 7. Supergrass, 7. Guess Who, 6. They ought to have a lot more votes than that. I know we put them on late, but they should have a lot. And they also don't belong in this poll. Do you think?
Who cares anymore?
Oh, we don't care. XTC, 6. Joy Division, 6. Marillion, whatever that is, 5. 10cc, 5. The Ramones, 4. Foreigner, 4. The Turtles, 4. Bando and Almonds got 4. How do you like that, huh? Fear.
Ooh.
Veer. Husker Du has got 4. I think I'm finally getting the hang of that. Dave Clark, 5, 3. Traveling Wilburys, 3. Daddy Warhols has got 3. Daddy Warbucks ain't got one yet. The Smiths have got a pair. The Isley Brothers, 2. Oh, I got one for you. The Thompson Twins.
Okay.
You don't like them?
Mm, I mean, I did, and then, you know, they destroyed it. Like,
I mean, they were only around for like 5 minutes, but they're pretty good. I like them. Isley Brothers, 2. Counting Crows, 2. Bread has got a pair. NRBQ's got 2 that he just called in. Crazy Horse, 2. Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers has got a pair, and he's still really dead. The Spinners have got only 1, and we just put up Mothers of Invention, Rare Earth, and the Zombies don't have it. The Zombies we put up quite a while ago. They have the big nothing so far. She's not there, though.
Nope, not anymore.
Boy, did they play that on Zeta? Oh, that Petey Bulger, man. Thank goodness that nobody put CCR. Oh, thank God for that. And hey, how come we don't have Little Feet on there yet, man?
Because we weren't gonna.
Why not? Just because I hate them like poison, and Petey Bulger played that up the Little Feet up the ass at Zeta.
Ripped that guy for suggesting it?
Yeah. But nonetheless, there are people, they were all popular. Right. They sold a couple of records here and there. Don't ask me how. Hey, speaking of Little Feet, when you shop for quality footwear, great selection and professional service, what a segue, man. It just astonishes me the kind of crap we fall into. You know what? The only problem is when we come out, we smell unlike Greg Reed. There's only one place to get your feet taken care of, and that's Brandy Shoes in Pompano Beach. The biggest selection of men's and women's shoes is waiting for you, the best service as always, and the best prices in town that are always unbeatable. At Brandy's, you find the top names in the shoe business. They got them all. They got Rockport's, Florsheim, SAS, Sperry, Timberland Naturalizer, and lots more. And I guarantee you, I'll bet Greg's and Duff's and Clarence's lives all on it that whatever you're looking for, whatever style is in stock right now on a shelf, ready to slap on your smelly feet. Brandy's is open daily, Monday through Saturday, 9 to 9, Sundays 10 to 5, and you'll find them at 1290 North Federal Highway in Pompano Beach. It's always worth the trip no matter where you are. And all this week at Brandy's again, it's a great time to buy SAS because all great men's and women's styles continue to be 25% off. So be sure this week to get into the store or check them on the web at brandyshoes.com.
Listening to Neil Rogers exclusively on 560.
Bush.
Hey, this is Dick Cheney. Not only did I approve this ad, but I strongly advise you pay close attention if you know what's good for you.
Hey, how you doing? How you doing? This is Johnny Two Times. They call me Johnny Two Times because I say everything two times. Two times. I was employed by certain parties, to perform a service for my country. So I can't say who, because I'm a soldier. You got to use your finger to vote on the rigged computer machines. Your finger, see? We get your prints, so we know who you are. That's right, we know. So if we find out who voted for that draft dodger Kerry, John Kerry, you'll be visited by one of our associates. who will proceed to shove a towel down your throat and chop off both your legs with a shovel. A shovel. So if you don't want to get hurt, vote for Bush. And if you don't believe me, read the paper. Read the paper.
Well, let me tell you something, my crunk, Mick friend.
You know, I'm thinking, because that music is from the movie, obviously, and I'm trying to think of where in the movie that music is from, and it's driving me nuts.
That little interlude there?
Yeah.
Didn't they use it more than once?
I don't know, like, but little... I mean, it's, I'm trying to think of even one would be good, would pacify me for the moment. I don't know.
I know. I
what
know.
Is it?
In Godfather 2,
yes?
When they're doing the, hey, I got a free carpet for you.
Oh, yeah, that's right. When Clemenza takes them in there to the house where the people are away and they break into the house and they roll up that gigantic carpet.
On, you know, and bringing the carpet out.
Absolutely. Very good. That was outstanding. Almost as good as...
Do you know who I am? I'm Mo Green. I made my bones when you were going out with cheerleaders.
Bad news for some of the people with their shutters. Maybe it's not such a good idea to put up shutters. I don't know if you heard this story about the priest in Fort Lauderdale.
No.
Catholic priest was killed in a house fire Tuesday night, last night, after efforts to rescue him were hampered by hurricane shutters covering the windows. Boy.
Oh, that's tragic somehow.
The Reverend Jorge Sardinas, 53, apparently tried to fight the blaze with a garden hose before he was overcome by heat and flames.
Flaming,
said Fort Lauderdale Police Sergeant Alfred Lewis Jr. No relation to Don Irvine Jr. Neighbors called to report the fire in the 3200 block of Southwest 20th Court at 10:30 in the p.m. When firefighters arrived, they found heavy smoke and flames coming from the house. They had trouble getting into the house because hurricane shutters still covered most of the windows, and then the sun suddenly got the pictures here. It really hindered our efforts to get into the house, said Battalion Chief Philip Pennington. If there's a lesson to be learned, it's take your shutters down after a storm in case of a fire. Yeah, well, wait a minute. Weren't they telling us to leave our shutters up until like just 5 minutes ago because of Ivan?
They did.
We've only had the all clear on Ivan for about just a few minutes.
About 30, man.
Right?
Right.
Sardinas was an art professor at St. Thomas University in Miami and a priest at Our Lady of the Lakes Catholic Church in Miami Lakes, Lewis said. He was found unconscious on the floor near a bedroom, and paramedics administered CPR before taking him to Broward General. His dog was found dead inside the house. Damn. So you got a Catholic priest and a dog. Now, if I had my druthers, oh, I'm sorry.
Something
that was
choking.
Bad, wasn't it? Pennington said Sardinas took down only a few shutters after recent storms to allow light into the house. Lewis said Fort Lauderdale fire arson investigators and police homicide detectives were investigating the blaze, but they had no reason to suspect foul play. Pretty upset about that dog, I'll tell you that right now. And, speaking of upset, this bitch, well, and of course I shouldn't be talking about such stuff on Erev Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish New Year.
Oi!
But I will anyway. Your favorite. Oh, REO Speedwagon. I can't stand them, but that's a good one for the poll.
We'll put it on there. REO Cheesewagon.
Yeah. Almost as outstanding as the Duran Duran, but not quite. REO Speedwagon. We'll put it on there to make you feel better about your life, okay, and about your taste, such as it is. Fresh from her acclaimed reinvention tour, pop idol Madonna embarks today on a spiritual pilgrimage to Israel to practice her newfound faith in the mystical Jewish Kabbalah. Kabbalah?
Kabbalah.
Kabbalah. See, I was trying to say it wrong, and now I'm so confused about it, I can't figure out which one is
Punta
wrong.
Corda.
I really don't give a crap. It's all a bunch of crap is what it is, okay? Kushmir and Tuchus, as they say in China. Orthodox Jews afraid of the growing popularity of the movement among non-Jews is nothing more than a trend that demeans. Call up Joyce in Fort Myers and in Naples, wherever she is over there, and ask her if I can say Kushmir and Tuchus, all right? That goy is your cup. What the hell does she know about it? Tell her to call up Dr. Judy Dean. She'll explain it to her. I got to play that. Orthodox Jews are afraid the growing popularity of the movement among non-Jews is nothing more than a trend that demeans their religious beliefs. There is nothing that could demean the beliefs of Orthodox Jews, trust me when I tell you, or any of the other devout of any religion, sect, unit, Bubba Mises, fairy tales, bullcrap. Madonna, who recently adopted the Hebrew name Esther, oh my God, did you know that?
Yes, I did.
Her name is Esther,
yes,
and she's going back to school for a semester.
She's very
and then at the
now.
End of the term, we can test her.
You test her.
And then she'll come to your house and pester until you can't stand it no more. She adopted the Hebrew name Esther, wears a trademark Kabbalah red string on her wrist. What is that supposed to do?
To remind you.
Of what? That you're Jewish?
Yeah, that you think you are.
Has said she's serious about her belief in Jewish mysticism and irritated by accusations that her faith is nothing more than a celebrity fad. Oh, she certainly wouldn't do nothing like that. Not that bitch.
No.
Talk about smelly. Yet for many of the, her fellow followers of Kabbalah, or at least those congregating around Judaism's Western Wall, the litmus test will be just how much fabric the material girl wears over her arms, shoulders, and legs. She should dress modestly instead of showing off her body, commented one woman selling books about the Kabbalah near the Western Wall in Jerusalem, one of Judaism's holiest sites. I can't believe they even let women near that. Don't the Orthodox Jews throw rocks at the women that go to the Wailing Wall? Yes, they do.
Let's hope they throw them at her.
Ultra-Orthodox Jews frown upon women wearing pants, let alone the raunchy, anatomically exaggerated bustiers and fishnet stockings synonymous with a Madonna concert. They took one look at that and they would go, feh. Madonna, whose itinerary was kept under wraps for security reasons, was expected to celebrate the Jewish New Year, Rosh Hashanah, at a luxury hotel in Tel Aviv with about 2,000 fellow Kabbalists from the L.A.-based Kabbalist Center. Oh, what? Where did this come from? Where did the, you know what this reminds me of?
What's that? Scientology?
My whole life, I went, you know, minded my own business, rolling along, singing a song. All of a sudden, there became this thing, born-again Christians. I never heard of such a thing. Mm-hmm. And now, all of a sudden, my whole life, as a dietary Jew only, and rolling along, having gone through that phony baloney business with the bar mitzvah and all that nonsense, and now it's this Kabbalah. Where did this come from?
Jews.
Pop star Britney Spears, another bubblehead, who exchanged an intimate kiss with Madonna in an MTV award show. Maybe that's where they got the exchange. Maybe it rubbed off on her. Huh?
Oh, I got a line.
I know you do, and back in the day, probably would have tried to get away with it. Not now you won't, though. Let me tell you right now. It didn't pass the muster test. Britney Spears and Hollywood actress Demi Moore also are followers of Kabbalah, although neither will be joining Madonna in Israel. I wonder about Ashton Kutcher, Kutcher, since he's doing Demi Moore, allegedly. He really irritates the hell out of me. They're just some of these people. I don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. He bugs me.
Good. Be bugged.
I'm just telling you, he just gets on my nerves. Well, what's the and that show, that 70s show? Have you ever tried to watch that show?
Yeah, there's a girl I like on there, but it's not a funny show.
Well, I guess I could have liked him too a few years ago. Although he's starting to get really bizarre looking, like this spaceship has just landed. But that show is just every character on there is. I'm not going to say a little over the top. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like that simpering queen, that beaner queen, or whatever that thing is supposed to be on there. See, one good thing about TV that I really appreciate is that they don't bring on these exaggerated stereotypes. You know what I'm talking about? In Judaism, Kabbalah means, did I say it right?
Yes.
Kabbalah means literally, I don't know how you say it, and frankly, I couldn't care less. What has been handed down? Oh, writings dating to the Middle Ages and oral teachings. Can we say oral?
No.
Oral teachings which are held by the faithful to describe the true nature of God and man to reveal the secrets of creation. In other words, Bubba Mises, which literally translated means old wives' tales, word of mouth, fables, as Aesop, even Aesop would be embarrassed. Madonna's Kabbalist congregation, which ascribes to a New Age brand of mystical Judaism, were to pray and meditate over the holiday, observe the Yom Kippur fast day next week. Are you going to be observing Yom Kippur? I'm not.
I am.
I'm going to be eating like a pig on that day. I'm going to be like picking out cheeseburgers, bacon, pork chops.
That's how I'll be observing it. And by
I'm
going to
be eating so much trafe next week, I'm going to rot in hell an extra 100,000 years. How do you like that, huh? And I'm going to like it a lot. Yeah. No, you have to have two sets of dishes. And by the way, tell Gary Sarner for me, Kasachois, when you see him.
Okay.
Yeah. Give him a big, bright smile. 20 till 2 at 560 WQM. This is one of those times when many of you might need help fast. Thankfully, Dial-A-Mattress delivers the same day all across South Florida. That's right. Same day you call them. When you call 1-800-MATTRESS, you'll choose from the deepest and widest selection of bedding, all available for same-day delivery. Call 1-800-MATTRESS right now and get you factory-direct prices and immediate delivery. And as always, you still get to pick the date and two-hour window for your schedule to fit when you're going to be there. And Dial-A-Mattress is on time 99.7% of the time. Dial-A-Mattress is ranked the best in the world in customer satisfaction. These folks were winners of the 2004 Better Business Bureau Local Torch of Excellence Award. They give you an unbeatable deal all the way around, including the top names in the business. They got Sealy, Serta, King Coil, Simmons, Tempur-Pedic, even Stearns and Foster Hewitt. Everybody with a brain is calling them, and you ought to be doing the same. If you have a need today for a new bedding, don't put it off a minute longer. Log on to their website, mattress.com, or make that easy toll-free call just sitting there on your fat, lazy ass. Call 1-800-MATTRESS, 1-800-M-A-T-T-R-E-S.
You're listening to Neil Rogers, exclusively.
Q-A-M. Pump, pump, pump.
Oh, I don't know what it is about them, their whiny little voices or their big noses, goofy hats. tiny little schmeckles. I don't know, they just rub me the wrong way.
Anti-Semitism lives in every speech Hillary gives. It's in the news. Hillary hates Jews. Spewing hatred through the halls, busting people's matzo balls. It's in the news.
Oi!
Hillary hates Jews. You won't catch her lighting a menorah.
No.
God, she must have a wonderful aura. When she speaks, I wanna cry. She could use a good rabbi. It's in the news.
Oh, boy!
Hillary hates Jews.
145. I guess the Mad Dog is gonna be on. Can you take a look in there and see? Is he in the building?
He's in there. He's in there. We just got a report.
You gotta be kidding me.
I wouldn't.
I am amazed and just shocked. Aren't you? He must be in there for other reasons. Maybe he's recording stuff or, huh?
I don't know. Maybe it's payday.
It is not payday. It's not even close to payday.
Well, I'm just throwing guesses out.
Man, how the mighty have fallen. I cannot believe that. Big name, beloved from coast to coast, from pillar to post. Superstar. Probably the number one ex-jock broadcaster in the country today, now that Pat Summerall is, like, fading into oblivion, wouldn't you think? Who else would be?
What about Tony Siragusa?
Yeah, right. Or that obnoxious Tim McCarver that won't shut up. No, I think Mad Dog's right up there. At any rate, he is there today. It's like a bonus.
All right.
For the audience. 30 minutes of the Mad Dog. Well, I guess he's probably doing it just so we can say to me, see, I'm only on for a half an hour, big shot, and I'm still getting paid. Yeah, good point. Five women whose husbands died in the 9/11/2001 attacks on the World Trade Center threw their support behind John Kerry yesterday, saying the Democratic presidential challenger would keep America safer by refocusing U.S. efforts to defeat al-Qaeda. The quintet, who were joined by a survivor of the attack on the Pentagon, said they had been rebuffed by President George W. Bush in every attempt to have a proper investigation into their husband's death and said it sullied the memory of their loved ones to have the war in Iraq linked to the attacks. After watching the Republican convention in New York, I'm scared, said Kristen Breitweiser of Middleton, New Jersey, whose husband Ron died more than 3 years ago. I'm scared that my daughter, who's 5 years old, is being handed a tomorrow that'll be a war for a lifetime. My husband was killed on 9/11. I don't want to lose my daughter 18 years from now when she's living or working in a big city and it's payback for our actions in Iraq. I'm scared about what could happen over the next 4 years. Security and remembrances of 9/11 were central to the Republican convention held a mere 6 kilometers. What is that, like 3.5 miles, from New York's ground zero, and Homeland Security has become the cornerstone of Bush's reelection bid. Former New York Mayor Rudy Giuliani, New York Governor George Pataki, and a litany of other speakers told Republican delegates that Americans could remain safe under a second Bush term, while Kerry would offer a mushy response to terrorists that would make the country more vulnerable. But the women who came forward yesterday said they had a fight to convince the Bush administration to agree to the 9/11 Commission, then fought to convince him to properly finance it, then had to fight him to give it enough time to do its work. They say the war in Iraq has become a recruitment tool for terrorists bent on striking the U.S. again and has allowed Osama bin Laden and his followers to regroup. We spent 14 months begging for a commission to be established, and we found it was President Bush who thwarted our efforts at every turn, said Patty Casaza of Colson Neck, New Jersey. Lori Van Auken of East Brunswick, New Jersey, said the Bush administration took its eye off the ball by invading Iraq before its work was done in Afghanistan and al-Qaeda training camps are still operating. And you listen to this, and you read all of this, and you read all of these bedtime stories, and you open up your book or a newspaper, anything. You go on our website, and you ask yourself, how is it possible that the Democratic Party could be so inept? How is it possible that John Kerry couldn't be 15, 20, 30, 40 points ahead?
About 30, man.
Whatever. Am I right?
Yeah.
And you have to hand it to them. They may not be good, but at least they're consistent. And guess what books are coming out today, speaking of that?
What's that?
The Family by Kitty Kelly. I think that's really interesting that the name of her book, unveiling all the truth about this disgusting family, going back all the way to George Herbert Walker Bush, old grandpa who never met a Nazi he didn't like. The Family. Don't you see something there?
I don't care how many Dago, Guinea, Wop, Greaseball, Goombas come out of the woodwork.
Yeah. That comes out today. And also the other one, the Seymour Hersh book, is out today also. So I'm going to go out and get those immediately, if not sooner. And maybe even once in a while, since we occasionally drop in some of these bedtime stories when Miguel's not there because he doesn't like it, we'll read a few excerpts from that.
Good.
Kitty Kelly's The Family. And, of course, that Sharon Bush, the former daughter-in-law, man, she's trying to cover her ass big time. And they tried to make Kitty Kelly look really moronic and idiotic, like they always do on CNN this morning, try to put her into a corner, which she wouldn't have any part of. And she, I swear, and she said, well, Sharon Bush is trying to, like, recant what she said because she's scared. And who is that bimbo on CNN? Whoever that idiot was.
Insert generic bimbo number.
Yeah,
three.
Generic bimbo. And, oh, well, scared of what? Scared of what? Oh, my God. So there you go. It's in the bookstores today, The Family by Kitty Kelly, the real story about these grave robbers. And, of course, they got some real serious plans, some devious plans for the next, let's see, 4, 8, 16, for the next 100 years. Like I said yesterday, they got fat-ass Governor Jeb Bush. They want him to have 8 years after this bozo finishes if the world is still in one piece. And then they got George P. once he quits driving around in circles in his girlfriend's parking lot. 10 minutes before. And like you said, maybe Noelle, once she gets out of rehab. Hey, if it was good enough for W, it's got to be good enough for her, right?
Sure.
It kind of runs in the family. Maybe they have a nose problem.
Yeah, their nose runs in the family.
That might be it. If you're on the Atkins, South Beach Sugar Busters, or any low-carb, sugar-free diet, we want you to head for Delights of West Boca because you're going to love this store. It's all for you. For years, Delights has helped thousands of low-carb dieters achieve their weight loss goals, and now Delights of West Boca will be celebrating their 14th anniversary with special discounts of up to 50% off on low-carb products like Carbolite, Purity Light, CarbSense, and lots more. And as their anniversary super special, you can save half off at 50% all their Atkins food brands, brand foods and supplements, too. Don't forget the great selection you'll find at Delights of low-carb bakery items like cheesecakes, breads, rolls, brownies, and all kinds of other great stuff. And don't forget, you can try anything in the store. Just taste a little sample before you buy it. They have a knowledgeable staff that knows low-carb dieting inside and out, and they're open daily till 10. Don't forget their guaranteed lowest price policy on all Atkins, Carbolite, and Purity Light products, too. Delights of West Boca will positively, absolutely not be undersold. You'll find them on the northeast corner of Glades and 441, right next to Boston Market, or... By the way, how many sides do you get with your main order at Boston Market? Or call them toll-free at 1-877-LOW-CARB or on the web, lowcarb.com, L-O-W-C-A-R-B. That's Delights of West Boca, the one and only, your official Atkins Retail Center.
The Howard Stern Show. Neil Rogers, mornings and midday. And sports around the clock. 560 QAM.
This is the Neil Rogers Show. This is your brain. Any questions?
Michael Jackson has asked the judge in his trial for permission to speak out about his alleged mistreatment at the hands of the Santa Barbara Police Department.
It was awful. They plucked me from my warm, cozy California King bed while I was watching reruns of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. They stormed my mansion like I was Saddam Hussein. They were calling me horrible names like, hey you, and stop running, and sit right there. I tried to defend myself by saying, I am rubber and you are glue, and whatever you say bounces off me and sticks to you, but it did not stop them. They spilled my milk all over my furry white bunny slippers and smashed my bubble-making machine to smithereens. I tried to keep them out of my secret room by throwing pixie stick dust in their eyes, but they kept coming. It was a nightmare. Why are the police allowed to treat people this way? I am an upstanding citizen who wants only to have his privacy and an occasional sleepover theme party. Who's to say my guest didn't want to play the popular party game, What's in My Pocket? That is my business and the business of the family's defense attorney, not the police. I have bruises on my new nose and red marks on my buttocks, though that's not from the police. They shackled my wrists and shoved the bashi ball into my mouth and said, who's bad? Actually, maybe that was a dream I had last night. Never mind. So please, police people, you need not be ruffians or say nasty things to me. Sticks and stones may break my elephant man bones, but names, they also hurt me. Ow!
Okay, we got the Mad Dog standing by. He'll be along for a really pressure-packed half hour between 2 and 2.30. The Marlins on deck at 2.30, and we got the doubleheader at PP Park. Expos in town, and of course, both of those games, forget about it. No problem, right?
Yeah, no problem.
Marlins sweep. That's what George predicts. Anyway, right. Here's the result in the poll so far. We got 538 votes. most underrated rock group of all time. We apologize for some of the ones on here that really are much too popular to be on here, but nevertheless, Sublime 50, Holly's 46, The Kinks 44, Steely Dan 42, and believe me, if you heard their music, you'd be out of gas too. Rush 38, Jethro Tull 31, Doobie Brothers 29, Radiohead 25, The Animals 23, Cream 19, King Crimson 12, Sweet 12, Sweet, Talking Heads 11, The Pet Shop Boys 10, Smith's 9, Foreigner 9, Crowded House, and we left Hanson off of here. It's just a joke, but before he puts it on there, it's just a little joke. Foreigner 9, Crowded House 9, Supergrass 9, Guess Who 8, only 8, Grand Funk Railroad 8, Marshall Tucker Band 8, Berlin 7, Joy Division 7, Ramones 6, XTC 6, Counting Crows be having 5, Marillion 5, 10cc 5, Dave Clark 5, 4, Traveling Wilburys 4, Turtles 4, Band on an Omen's got 4. How do you like that? That Husker Du has got 4, and the other ones, believe me. Tiny, teeny, tiny potato.
Bye, bye, bye!
Our Scott Show. Neil Rogers and Sports Talk. Round the clock. Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
Come on in and lay down on my couch.
Bible says two men ought not lay together.